Because...
Wait, sorry.
My girl wants to party all the time?
Go ahead. Do the thing.
Oh, Heather in Bountiful said, Herbie Hancock. Is it Herbie Hancock's birthday today?
It is.
In Bountiful. Is it?
Bountiful? Herbie Hancock, 84. A respected jazz musician to this day who had a hit in the 80s with that song.
Does not sound like anything else
he
ever did.
That is not indicative of what Herbie does.
No.
I think it was the video, really, that made it popular.
Yeah, that came about when MTV was first.
Mm-hmm.
And there were five...
And they were like...
Five videos, so we saw
anything on, yeah.
So we're like, what else? What else you got? We got this instrumental thing from... Fine, put it on. We don't...
do that.
We don't have very many videos.
He's fine, by the way. He's just fine.
Bill is not fine, though.
No.
I guess. Got a text at 3:30 this morning that said, I don't have a voice. I have a cold. What I have is a cold. What I don't have is a voice. And you never got it, Carrie.
I didn't get that text, no.
I don't know what Katie and I got it, but I don't know why you did not get that.
Well, I mean, he sent me some stuff, you know, and he doesn't usually.
Yeah.
You know, he sent me some stuff in email.
But you didn't get a message that he was
ill today. But it was notes for today, you know. But I didn't get his text. You see, I've switched from one major... cell carrier to a different one.
And how'd that work out for you?
I'm getting the same crappy service, but I'm paying less for it.
Oh, well, so there, that's
very happy
that's
about
positive.
That. I went from like 150 a month to like 15 a month, and it's the same crappy service. Hmm. I'm in this area in
Is
my
it because
house
where you live. You're in a zone.
It didn't used to be that way. Okay. I used to be able to use my phone at home. But in the past 5 years, I haven't been able to use my phone at home. And so we thought, well, let's switch carriers. Let's see what happens.
Nope. But is it kind of nice? Can that be your out for things? Like, sorry, my phone doesn't work at my house. Sorry, you'll have to get a hold of me tomorrow.
I mean, it works sometimes to my advantage, but most of the time, like this morning, it didn't. Because I come in and you're scrambling to find boners, and I'm like, what? What's going on?
I'm like, because usually if I'm filling in for Bill, I have some time to, like, I know the day before, so I look for stuff. And this morning I'm like, okay, sure, I can do Bill. I can be Bill today, sure. Why not? But I think I found some, so.
You did?
I think so.
Okay. I was going to say, if folks are, you know, have one, maybe they could send it to you.
No, I've passed them along to the producer's booth.
We're committed. We're in.
Yeah. We're locked.
It has been set and locked.
But if you have any stories you think I should do in the news, you can email them to me. Gene@x96.com.
Let's see. I was going to see if, Gerke not coming in today. I thought he'd talk about Mayor Ted.
Oh, yeah, that was...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I had to scold Frank Crist.
Well, Frank didn't take Ted.
But Frank was... Frank usually sends out a little tweet for his tragedies.
Yes.
And he said that Ted is where all... Ted Wilson, former mayor of Salt Lake, he said Ted Wilson went where all politicians go. He went to hell. And I said, no, Ted's one of the good ones. Ted went to the good place. He didn't go to hell.
That's true. We don't run that Twitter account.
No, we
just
don't.
Just so you know.
That's somebody else.
Somebody else does that.
And we don't know who, actually.
We have no idea. We have no idea who runs that Twitter account. We have no idea who is the all-knowing suit, whom has disappeared,
Yeah,
it
I don't
seems.
Know where he went. Not officially affiliated as such.
Because... anybody can make any Twitter account.
It's true.
But, of course, if you're a Utah legislature, you'll believe everything that you read. it's on the Internet. It must be true.
You can't put things on the Internet that aren't true.
You can't just make stuff up.
No.
You can't just say you're the Grim Reaper and make pronouncements that people are going to hell.
I wonder how Frank tweets, you know, because he doesn't really have fingers. He has finger bones. You'd think that'd be...
Isn't there like a maybe he put a you know like a finger condom
the rubber tip
things Would that work?
Speaking of bad phones, I was having trouble with my car, my phone pairing with my car.
Oh, yes. The Bluetooth. I hate that.
And so I took it to the dealer, and there was a recall, too, that I needed to go in and get. Like the charger for my electric, you know, plug into the garage. There's a recall on it because it can set on fire. It can start a fire.
Oh,
so
really?
It's kind of an important recall. So I took it in for that, and I said, while you're here, my phone doesn't talk to my car.
Mm-hmm.
And they checked the car. They're like, the car is fine.
Mm-hmm.
It's your phone. It's your phone.
Huh.
Which I'm not going to get a new phone just so it can talk to my car. But
it's not talking at all?
It cuts in and out.
Mine too.
Yeah.
Mine's been doing that too.
Really?
Yeah. I'll be driving along and suddenly it's just gone.
Which these are very first world 2024 problems.
Well, that's where we live, so I'm okay complaining about this stuff.
Okay.
I hate that. First world problems. Shut up.
That's where I live,
all right?
If I lived somewhere else, I would have different
problems. I'd have a different set of problems. Thanks to my zip code, I can get an abortion for now. Anyway.
It's okay.
Still a full show today, though.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We've got movie reviews. I hope we're hearing about Civil War.
I think he's reviewing Civil War.
Okay, yeah, Katie says yeah.
And what else is he reviewing? I hope he's reviewing that Boy Kills World. Is that this week or next week?
Oh, I don't know. Or the Ryan Reynolds Imaginary Friend one. Is that this week? If
not this week?
Oh.
No. Well, at least we'll get Civil War for sure.
And have another drink with Jimmy. This is a day when we have Jimmy in for two breaks, which means you could call and ask him booze-related, etiquette-related, restaurant-related questions.
We got Boner of the Day coming up. We got Gina.
Lots of stuff to give away. Mm-hmm. Dashboard confessional tickets, Glass Animals tickets, 21 Pilot tickets.
Mm-hmm. The Beat Gina trivia is... Now, when I say it, you're going to go, why? Andy Garcia trivia.
Okay.
He was in a lot of movies.
Yeah.
Okay? He's in a lot of movies.
I like Andy Garcia.
So we got those.
He was in Mamma Mia.
Escape from Germany? Escape from Germany is a real movie? I thought somebody was making that up.
Ooh, I don't know.
Okay. La Chimera.
Is Kurt Russell in it?
I hope not. And Civil War. Yeah, so those are the movies that Sean will be reviewing at 7 o'clock. So stand by for all of that, and
This has been Farting Around with Carrie, Bill, and Gina on X96, Radio from Hell.
All right, check-ins begin. If you have a mind to, call 877-602-9696 to check in with the Radio from Hell program.
You can text in, too.
You can text 33986. That's another way to check in with us. Let us know you're there. Give us a reason to continue doing the show.
To go on.
Yes.
Give us a reason to go on.
UtahAdvocates.com.
You know, the advocates, they're there to advocate for you if you've been injured in an accident, but they're also advocating for people that need help. The Murray Children's Pantry works year-round to provide meals for families in our community, and there is a bigger need during the summer months because these are kids that get free breakfast, free lunch at school. You're not in school, that's you're not getting as many meals.
Mm-hmm.
The pantry is where the Advocates is doing their donations this month. You can bring in a non-perishable food, that's like peanut butter, chili, canned fruits and vegetables, that kind of thing. You can drop it off at any Advocates office, and you can find their locations at UtahAdvocates.com. Or if it's just easier for you to donate money, you can Venmo at Advocates Donations, and they'll do the shopping for you.
All right.
Are you ready to make a difference this early?
It can't be good, the German muffin.
The German muffin. I wonder what a German muffin
is. It's really dry, I bet. It's really...
It's kind of aggressive.
Yeah.
Harsh. Its language is not romantic. The German muffin. It's very efficient, though.
Sure.
Let's see. Well, I guess we should begin. 621, let's get this over with.
Yeah, and you can call us and check in 877-602-9696 or text us 33986. The moon is a waxing crescent moon, and it is Friday, the 12th day of January, February, March. Is it April already? It's April. 12th day of April. Forgive me. I got the early morning text from Bill, and now I've been trying.
At least you got a text.
Yeah,
okay. I didn't.
Yeah. In the year of our Lord 2024.
Yeah. Thank you.
And this is the Radio from Hell show, starring the Lords of Morning Radio, Carrie Jackson, Bill Allred not here, Gina Barberi here, and scrambling. I'm sorry. It's Big Wind Day.
Big Wind.
The day commemorates the recording of the highest natural wind gust measured on the Earth's surface. It was on the afternoon of April 12, 1934. Winds blowing 231 miles per hour were recorded by Mount Washington Observatory. Big Wind Day. It's also a day of silence, so maybe we should just go home.
Yeah.
Hamster Day, because you got to love a hamster. National Grilled Cheese Sandwich Day.
Oh,
National Licorice Day, and International Day for Street Children. Doesn't explain that. Just International Day for Street
Children. International Day for Street Children.
Mm-hmm. But grilled cheese, Carrie, you have a secret grilled cheese recipe you have shared previously.
Oh, it's a wonderful thing. Now, we're a Miracle Whip house, so people...
You're not a mayonnaise?
We're both.
Oh.
We enjoy both. Each for a different occasion.
Oh, okay.
But what we do is, and most people use mayonnaise to do this, but we do it with Miracle Whip.
Okay.
You spread the Miracle Whip on the outside of the grilled cheese sandwich before you put it in the pan. Sizzle it up. Because
It gets crispy, I'm guessing.
It gets crispy, and you get that tangy zip of Miracle Whip taste. Delicious.
I'm surprised you will have Miracle Whip. But you don't do margarine, right? No margarine in your house?
No.
No.
God, no.
Butter only.
Butter. Absolutely.
Salted or unsalted?
Salted preferred.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm finding out what's in margarine. And, yeah, you don't want that in your body.
Isn't it like gasoline?
It's essentially a petroleum product, you know. And I'm like, God, I remember my dad yelling about how, okay. He said, I don't want that Nuco in our house.
What's Nuco?
I guess that was a brand of margarine back then. And I was like, but it's good.
And it's smooth. And it spreads so easily.
Exactly.
It's always soft.
And I don't want that Nuco in the house.
You shouldn't trust things that are always soft, right?
But he was right.
Yeah.
He was right. There's nothing but bad stuff in there.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's see. Sean is going to review Escape from Germany, texter. Text check-ins, 877-602-9696 if you want to call. Gina's sign-off today. I'm scrambling to find boners.
Perfect. I'll do that.
Good morning. Right wing Wade checking in from I-15. All lanes moving along great.
Thanks, Wade.
April in American Fork checking in. I'm taking my mom to get knee replacement surgery today by a robot arm. The future is here. Wish her luck.
A robot arm? Does that mean like the doctor is in another state and he's doing it via a robot?
April, you need to call and give us more information. I don't know how that works. Does the robot just do it? Does he like turn it on and leaves the room and goes and gets a beer and comes back? No idea. Zane checking in. It's Friday. That's all.
That's all you need.
Ron the Carpenter with a Stephen Wright joke. If your car traveled at the speed of light, would your headlights work?
This is a good question. That's not a joke. That's a way homer is what that is.
Well, I could use the Star Trek physics book to explain it to you, but I don't have it with me. Johnny B checking in. Please keep doing the show. It was one of my main motivational forces on my house that I built 15 years ago, and I need it on the one I'm
Wait a minute, Johnny, this
now?
Isn't
what?
The first house you've built?
Oh, my goodness, Johnny. Also, I need day drinking with Jimmy. Everclear at the ready. Well, don't go that far.
I'm sure whatever Jimmy's bringing in today is tastier than Everclear.
Yeah, don't go that far. Cardboard Chris checking in. I'm heading to the NoFX concert tomorrow at Rice-Eccles Stadium. I've never been to Rice-Eccles. Any suggestions or tips?
Well, I mean, there's going to be plenty of parking right there at the stadium, but but it's nice if you can take tracks.
Yes.
Because it will just dump you off right in front of the stadium, and you don't have to worry about parking.
Exactly.
That's my tip for you.
And go and see your dad's plaque.
Yeah, it's right there on Guardsman Way. You can pay respect.
All right. Let's see. Dan is here. Hello, Dan.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
What's up?
It's my first time checking in.
Well, thanks for doing it. Where are you headed this morning?
Oh, I'm going to go install some doors, doing a home remodel.
Yeah, the solid doors or the hollow ones?
We're doing a mix of both.
We cheaped out and did
the sound control. We're doing the solid.
We cheaped out and did the hollow ones, and we have door regret.
You have door regret?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Should have gone with the solid.
Well, especially with teenagers.
Yeah.
The noise and the satisfaction of slamming the door.
Yeah, there's no satisfaction closing a hollow door.
The hollow door, it's not, you know, it's not going to give you that same, boom, I'm angry. All right, Dan, thank you.
So, I just want to say quick, last year I listened to every single podcast. This year I'm missing 8, so if you guys could take another week off, I'll catch up.
All right.
Well, yeah, for you.
Listen.
I think we need to make this happen.
Gladly. Gladly we'll do it.
Thank you. Thank you for doing all that listening.
Thank you. All right.
We'll go to the boss and say we have to. They can't get caught up on the podcast.
Dan needs to get caught up. Let's see. I tuned in late. Is Bill okay? He's just sick. That's all.
He said he lost his voice.
Yeah. My abandonment issues are running abound. Mm-hmm. Meshack checking in. Hope everyone has a Rocket Friday. All right. How about some golden earring one morning for the best part of the day of farting around? Well, okay, maybe.
We could do that.
Oh, Kewpie mayo on the grilled cheese. Yes. Get the Kewpie mayo.
I've never heard of Kewpie mayo.
It's Asian. But you can get it at Costco.
What is
and
the difference?
There's more egg.
Oh.
It's more eggy, more yolky.
Okay.
I think. Or more what? There's more of something in it.
Okay.
But it's delicious, and it's in this squeezable bottle, and it's delicious.
All right.
Casper the Friendly Plumber checking in. Miracle Whip is the devil's condiment.
You mean that as a compliment, right?
I hope. Sid, I stopped eating margarine after we synthesized it in organic chemistry lab. Yeah, see, that's what I mean. Let's see. Happy birthday to my beautiful wife, Ashley. Can't wait to spend the whole weekend together. Brunch?
Oh, brunch is always a good idea. Brunch is never a question.
Exactly.
Brunch is always a statement.
Tyler the Trash Man, seconding Kewpie mayo on the grilled cheese. Let's see. All right. My mom had both knees replaced with a robot arm. Fastest recovery I've ever seen. Others with knee replacements are angry here. It was so easy.
Why does the robot arm make a difference?
Yeah, we need you to explain it to us. Mm. Shadrach here. Thanks for highlighting Big Wind Day. Big Wind was my nickname in high school. Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, jeez.
I'm so sorry that happened.
Let's see. Crash northbound I-15, milepost 329, that's 550 south in Layton. The right lane is closed. And I'll need extra help from Infiniteam today, because I can't keep as close an eye on traffic. But if you text in traffic you're seeing, that'll be super helpful. Just do that at 33986. X96 welcomes Nightmare on 13th return for their one-night-only Scream Break this April 13th. You can listen to Todd Newcomb all week long for your chance to win tickets. For contest details and ticket links, you can go to x96.com.
Robot arm has all the tools on it.
Mm-hmm.
The doctor assists.
Hmm.
It makes it more precise. I want to see this. There must be a YouTube video.
Right? I remember that. Remember that in Logan's Run where they had the robot surgery?
Oh, you should have seen Westworld. That was
All
right. We will take a break. We'll be back after some messages and a song. The song, Vinyl, from my Club Deviate DJing days.
Okay.
All right. So we got that coming up. But then Big Boy News, Opinuendo, and Frank Crist Presents, all coming up.
Speaking of live,
yes. I'm going to a concert tonight in Los Angeles.
Okay.
I feel weird about this. I was talking to Carrie about this off the air. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
Because I have this job.
Yes.
In radio.
Yeah.
Katie might understand what I'm talking about.
So, I might too if you'll tell me.
So we were on vacation last week and we were out of town, and my daughter Jonesy was upset because her very favorite artist was in town here last weekend. His name is Rule.
Okay. R-U-L-E?
R-U-E-L.
R-U-E-L. Okay.
And he's kind of like a Harry Styles, you know. He's a cute 20-something boy. Mm-hmm. I don't know anything about him. I don't know his music. I don't know. And, okay. she and her friends are nuts for him.
Yeah.
And she was all upset that we were going on vacation when he was coming here to Salt Lake.
And so you'll kowtow to a teenage girl being upset that she's missing a concert and pay a lot of money to go to Los Angeles.
My daughter has never asked for tickets to any concert. She's never expressed any interest in going to anything except for this. And I'm like, okay, if he's playing somewhere, this will be like your birthday present or whatever. If he's playing somewhere close, and it's a weekend, I don't have to take off work.
See, close would be like Provo.
Well, I said, we'll go. And I look, and he's playing in L.A. tonight.
Now, you said, I feel weird about this being in radio. Why?
But I don't know anything about this guy.
Gina, I'm in radio, and there are lots of things I don't know about in music.
But I don't know if his show here sold out, but I know it did very well.
I'm sure. That's the way music is these days. My kid listens to a lot of music and a lot of stuff I've never, and they'll play it for me, and I'll go, oh, that's really good.
Yeah.
They sold out the Complex the other night, and I'd never even heard of them. So.
But
that's the way music is today.
I mean, typical, you know, middle-aged mom, it makes sense to say, oh, my kid likes this artist. I don't know. I should know this.
It's also why radio is irrelevant.
Well, that's what Carrie and I
were talking. That was the discussion we had.
See, radio is irrelevant anymore when it comes to the music industry.
Yeah.
That's not what... People don't listen to this show because of music.
But
whoa,
but,
those alternative classics.
But we have to play a song.
At least a song, an hour. Well, I for one am glad we're doing that. It gives me breathing room.
So, you know, see, he's
he's fine.
He's a cute boy.
Yeah, he's fine. A little too precious for me, but okay.
He's the only poster she has in her room. Like,
well,
you know, I just. He came swinging like a portal. I'll be feeling it tomorrow.
Better be careful, there might be some dirty words in here.
but I'm doing the other thing that I also thought I would never do, which is I bought myself a ticket, and I'm going to stand in the back and let, you know.
Okay.
I'm not going to be like up there in the middle of it.
Why
it's not
you?
My thing.
No.
It's, But I never thought I would be that person that's standing in the back.
I would, if I went so far as to do what you're doing, I'd say, I'm dropping you off at the venue. I'll be over here at the lounge. When the show's over, I'll come and get you.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. I'll report back whether it's... I'm feeling like a normal mom.
And Gina, being in this business, you could have gone to Todd Newcomb, our program director, and said, Todd, my daughter really likes this artist.
Yeah.
And Todd would say, oh, I know the record company. I could probably get you tickets.
Well, I don't like asking.
Then don't bitch when you don't get it.
I'm not bitching.
This has been Farting Around with Carrie, Bill, and Gina on X96 Radio from Hell.
I'll ask every time. Because you know why?
Why?
I deserve it.
Now, we got a minute or two before we start Geek News. Mm-hmm. But, Gina, just real quick here. Hang on.
What?
Yeah? What do you got? A present? A snack?
Oh.
Snack. I know that color.
I want
means
snacks.
It's Reese's something.
This is the Reese's dipped animal crackers.
Ooh.
So they're dipped in the chocolate and yes. covered in the peanut butter. It says peanut butter candy.
Peanut butter candy? Huh.
I've had them. It's like the Reese's.
May I?
Go ahead. I just don't know if they can legally call it peanut butter, so maybe that's it.
It's like when something's called chocolate flavored.
Yeah, exactly. And then there's this.
What's that?
Reese's popcorn.
Why are you doing
Reese's
this to
popcorn.
Me?
Yeah. Everything you've ever wanted. Popcorn drizzled with your favorite candy.
Okay. Have you tried that?
I've not tried the popcorn.
No. Well, let's try that.
Okay, so these are supposed to be chocolate dipped animal crackers. What animal is that?
We ordered them. We couldn't find them in stores, so we ordered them through Target. They sat on the porch for a little bit too long.
It's a snake.
So, there, you want to try one?
It's the Loch Ness Monster or something. Okay. So they kind of melted a little bit.
A little bit.
So.
Oh, those are good.
Yeah, that's fun. That's a
ogre grub.
That's a ghost.
Looks like a ghost. I don't know what that is.
Oh, anyway, thank you, Carrie Jackson.
One. Mm. Oh, no, you should thank Sue, really. She's the one
thank you, Sue Jackson.
Who did
thank
all you. This.
Okay, let's
see.
The animal crackers popcorn. Are good. The animal cookies are good. I had those, but I haven't had the popcorn yet. Mm. I'll have
this
the popcorn.
Harder to open.
There's a tear at the top.
There we go.
Yeah.
Here we go. Okay. There, Carrie.
All right. Here you go. I'll have mine in a sec.
Oh, okay.
I'll be talking a lot with the geek.
See, this is good because they're a little salty.
Like, that's what I'm telling you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you got to have the little salt with a little bit of the sweet, and it evens out nicely.
Mm-hmm.
You like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah.
All right. Well, don't eat them all while I do geek news, okay? Because I got to have some.
All right.
New Order, True Faith, from the vinyl.
Oh, nice.
Because
why not?
Because why not? This is the same vinyl that I used when I DJ'd at Deviate.
Are there stains on it?
There should be. There really should
Deviate be. Deviate stains?
It was a... All right. Let's see. We do have big boy news now. And right after the big boy news, it's Frank Crist Presents They're Fine, They're Just Fine, the Dead Celebrity Game, where you get a chance to play and win. We'll give you four celebrity names. Three of them are fine. One of them dead. Pick the dead one correctly. You will win.
Tickets to see 21 Pilots coming August 18th to the Delta Center.
All right. 21 Pilots tickets at 877-602-9696. It's the number to call. Line up. Play. You'll win. I'm pretty sure of it.
Mm-hmm.
21 Pilots tickets. 877-602-9696. News now brought to you by...
No matter what kind of car you drive, two things are always true. All tires eventually need replacing. All vehicles need servicing. For quality service you can trust, visit your locally owned and operated Utah Big O Tires, the team you trust. John Bon Jovi is completely focused on recovery after having vocal cord surgery.
Oh.
I'm doing the news today, so I get to do stories.
Wait there. Living on a prayer.
Day to day, I'm working hard on it, John says. Nothing else matters. It's up to God at this point. So God, you know, there's war and famine and, mm-hmm. yeah. And kids with cancer. And but on his list mm-hmm. is...
Oh, I've got to get to that.
I got to get to John Bon Jovi's vocal cord healing to see if he will be able to tour again.
He did write a song, Living on a Prayer.
Yeah.
So maybe
that's for God, I bet. Sure. Yeah. Ted Wilson, who was elected 3 terms as mayor of Salt Lake City and narrowly lost a bid for governor, died on Thursday due to congestive heart failure and Parkinson's disease. He was 84. Wilson was elected mayor November 1975, served 10 years in office, leaving to become director of the Hinckley Institute of Politics at the University of Utah. He ran for U.S. Senate against incumbent Senator Orrin Hatch in 82, and in 1988 was Democratic nominee for governor. He would have been great in either of those positions.
Oh, yeah.
But much beloved local figure, Ted Wilson. He's Salt Lake County Mayor Jenny Wilson's dad.
Mm-hmm.
So we're thinking about that family at this time. We love Ted. He did lots of good for
all
of us.
Yeah.
Opening statements were delivered Wednesday in Chad Daybell's doomsday triple murder trial and the deaths of his first wife and 2 stepchildren.
Did you watch it all?
I didn't watch it all. No, I listened to some of it. Daybell's pleaded not guilty to murder and conspiracy charges stemming from the sensational homicide case, featured in a Netflix true crime documentary in 2022. I watched that.
Mm-hmm.
And it's there's so much there. It probably
there
requires
is.
A second watching.
Oh, absolutely.
Katie agrees.
There was so much happening. I was just, my mouth was agape.
Because these murders he's being tried for now are not all of the murders.
No, they're.
Lori's in Arizona now for a whole other murder. And there's more than that. It is so.
And it was the religious crazy, the religious crazy stuff that was fascinating to me.
The state describes him as a power-hungry, grandiose man who would stop at nothing for what he considered his rightful destiny. His defense lawyer portrayed Daybell as a religious man driven into an unfortunate relationship by a beautiful, vivacious woman who knew how to get what she wants. A grand jury in Idaho indicted Daybell and that woman, his second wife, Lori Vallow Daybell, on murder charges on the deaths of Vallow's 2 children, 16-year-old Tylee Ryan and 7-year-old J.J. Vallow. Daybell's also charged with the murder of his first wife, Tammy, who was initially believed to have died in her sleep. And then they started looking at it going, we better dig her up and check again. And yes, mm-hmm. come to find out she was murdered, didn't die of natural causes. He's cuckoo crazy.
Mm-hmm.
His desire for sex, money, and power led him to pursue ambitions to what he considered his rightful destiny, and that no person or law would stand in the way. And if you stand in the way, you're a dark spirit or a zombie.
Yeah, see that?
And so you got to get rid of it.
I just can't imagine being the kind of person who, if someone told me, God spoke to me and said this,
mm-hmm.
that I'd go, oh, yeah, yeah.
It's because you want to believe it, too. She wanted to believe it, too.
But... In the back of your mind, isn't there, like, as they say, a shadow of doubt?
You would think.
You know?
In his opening statement, his defense attorney, John Pryor, described his client as a religious man who wrote books about his faith, premonitions, good and evil, and the coming of the end of things when his savior, in his mind, was going to come back. He's one of these guys that said, oh, this is the day it's going to happen. And it was a couple of years ago that,
yeah.
Oh.
I just can't imagine being, ugh.
Pryor said Daybell's life began to change after he met Vallow Daybell, a beautifully stunning woman
who started giving him a lot of attention and eventually lured him into an inappropriate and unfortunate extramarital relationship. So they're putting it all back on Lori.
Oh, yeah.
He didn't want to kill his wife and kids. She made him do it. Yeah. Mm. It's a bit of a stretch.
Yeah.
Chad Daybell and Valor Daybell called themselves James and Elena and believed they were religious figures and had a system of rating people as light and dark, a prosecutor told jurors. The states accused the couple of using their doomsday religious beliefs to justify the killings. In particular, Daybell and Valor Daybell exchanged texts, and they have all this, about Tammy being in limbo and being possessed by a spirit named Viola.
Viola?
Yeah. In addition, Daybell was connected to a religious doomsday prepper website, which described itself as a series of lecture events focusing on self-reliance and personal preparation. He also had a podcast, too, that you can't find it anymore, but... yeah, I'll don't you worry. I'll be following this.
Yeah, please do. Yeah. It's the amount of crazy in this story.
Mm-hmm.
It baffles me that it got as far as it got.
Yeah.
That somebody didn't go, hey, wait a minute. We should not kill people, perhaps.
No, see, because the way they justify that in their mind is, that's not them anymore. They've been replaced by a
demon. They're not a person anymore. Yeah, they dehumanize them.
I'm doing them a favor.
Ah.
By dispatching with them.
I smell evil.
Yep. Salt Lake City man accused of plowing into six female pedestrians with his car and random attacks has been linked to two more hit and runs, says Salt Lake County District Attorney's Office on Thursday. On Pham, 26, is now facing three additional attempted murder charges connected to a March 2nd crash near 9th South 13th East in Salt Lake and another on March 12th, 166 North T Street in Salt Lake. It's taken them a while to piece this together because oftentimes hit and runs are just accidents,
yeah.
and they aren't able to find the person because the yeah. person that gets hit is like, I don't know, it was a white car. I didn't get the license number.
But this guy's a serial.
And I am predicting that we're going to find out that he's an incel because these are all women.
It's all women. Oh, okay, yeah.
All women he has purposefully hit with his car. So that's nine people he has hit in random attacks. All women. All women. BYU is losing their basketball coach, Mark Pope, who's been a great coach for them, actually. He's going to Kentucky. So it's a big step up for him.
I don't know about you, but I was losing sleep over this one.
No, I did. I lost no sleep.
No sleep
over
loss.
This. And actually, he's going to reportedly be paid one of the top paid basketball coaches in the country.
Good luck to him then.
So, and we don't know yet who they're going to get to replace him. As the dream of getting the 2034 Winter Olympics to Salt Lake City becomes more a reality, members of the International Olympic Committee spent Thursday touring various potential Olympic venues. It's an incredible day here, said Deandra Walsh, Park City Mountain VP. The day started at Olympic Park. IOC members saw bobsled, luge, skeleton track, one of only three like it in North America, and it is still in use every day. That's one of the reasons we're such a desirable place to have the Olympics. We have kept up our facilities.
Yeah, something I didn't think we'd do.
No, I mean, lots of other places spend millions and millions of dollars building this stuff, and then the minute the Olympics are done, it just rots.
It's just abandoned,
I love the idea of having just a few Olympic venues around the world, and we just rotate.
That's the way it should be, you know.
So it's because it's such a waste of money to
build
these things every 4 years.
The Olympics is a waste of money.
It would be good if we had them. I know we argue about this all the time, but. Good. You have tracks because of it.
Yes.
Let's see. You're going to need to help me out with time here.
Oh, give us another story here.
Well, you were wondering what Cato Kalin thinks about the OJ.
We were wondering where Cato Kalin
was. Where was Cato? Kids, if you don't remember, Cato Kalin, he claims to be an actor who was living in OJ Simpson's guest house at the time. Simpson's former wife and her friend were murdered. And he was part of the trial where he says he heard somebody, it was OJ, climb over the wall by his house and he heard a thud. Mm-hmm. What was that? It was O.J. climbing the wall to get back to the house after the murders.
Mm-hmm.
Cato hopes he's going to hopes he did penance before he died, because Cato's convinced he killed.
Well, yeah, we all are.
Yeah. Of course he did it.
I don't think there's anybody who, you know, thinks he's innocent, is there?
No, and Bill was asking yesterday, he said, Gina, did you read that book, How I Did It by O.J. Simpson? Because supposedly he wrote a book like, well, I didn't do it, but if I did it, this is what happened.
If I Did It is what it was called.
And I said, no, and then in my mind I'm like, why didn't I ever read that book? Because it never came out.
It didn't.
So he apparently wrote it, but it was... Lawyers said,
"Oh, the Goldman family, right?
Yeah,
they
I think so. So it's it
well, we
never.
Need, we need this book.
It never came out. Maybe it'll come out now.
Oh.
But other things are coming out. Carrie was saying he heard Keith Olbermann talking about.
Keith Olbermann does a podcast, which is mostly politics, but it was all sports today. And it was the first 20 minutes of it was how, you know, when he was working at ESPN. Everybody knew what a horrible person O.J. was before the murders.
Uh-huh.
And more people would have known if we had the internet. Because, you know, when the cops came to O.J.'s house 8 times before the murder, because he had beaten her so severely, there would have been camera footage. It would have been on Twitter right away.
But we don't
and
have
people
it.
Would have known. Uh-huh. So the secret about O.J. was kept. You know, he goes on about how this guy was... the most well-known, well-loved in, you know, sports, acting, entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
He was on television as a sportscaster. He was in the movies.
So you overlook these
He says,
things.
the only person I could compare it to would be is if we found out Taylor Swift murdered somebody, you know? It's that kind of star that we're talking about. And so he kind of puts it all in perspective. So if you go listen to it, it's Countdown. Keith Olbermann.
The Jazz won a game when it doesn't matter anymore, but they did. 124-121 over the Houston Rockets. They are on the road tonight against the LA Clippers. That is your sports weather. Wow, today sunny and we could get to 80. The prediction is 79. I'm just going to say let's go all the way to 80. Let's do it. Let's see if we can get there.
Let's try hard, kids.
Rest of the weekend looks beautiful too. Highs in the mid to upper 70s. Next chance of showers looks like it's going to be Sunday night into Monday, and things cool back down into the 60s. Traffic, let's see. We have crash ramp, southbound I-215 west, milepost 22. That's the exit ramp to go eastbound I-80. And what are you seeing on the roads? I need your extra help today. If you could text me what you're seeing, 33986. Utah First Credit Union's personal checking, where every feature comes standard. Learn more at utahfirst.com. Well, big day for you yesterday, Frank Chris.
I was very busy yesterday.
My good. You didn't even hint that OJ was on the horizon.
Well, we were keeping that a secret.
That's a big one.
In the family. You know, the family wanted it a secret.
It's Frank Christ. He's our friend and grim reaper of celebrity souls, and he joins us every day and doesn't tell us when he's got orders to go get somebody as big as OJ. We didn't know.
I can't talk about that stuff outside of the office.
Okay. Well, thank you for coming, Frank, because you're going to help us play a little game called Frank Christ Presents.
They're fine. They're just fine.
Frank's given Bill a list, and Bill passed it along to me. Of movies about orphans. These are all actors in movies about orphans. And there's 4 of them here. 3 of them, they're
fine. They're just fine.
One of them, not so fine, has passed away. And if someone can tell us who the dead celebrity is, we will give you tickets to 21 Pilots coming August 18th to the Delta Center.
Todd is on the phone.
Hi, Todd. Maybe.
Hi there.
Oh, there you are. Todd, how are you today?
I'm fine. I'm just fine.
Oh,
thank
that's
you,
good
Todd.
To hear. Todd, I'm going to give you this list, and you're going to tell me which of these celebrities is no longer with us so you can win those 21 Pilot tickets, okay?
Okay.
Number 1, Lily Sobieski. She achieved fame in her teens with roles in films such as Deep
Impact, Never Been Kissed, Eyes Wide Shut, Here on Earth, Joyride, The Glass House, nominated for an Emmy for Joan of Arc. In The Glass House, she played a character orphaned after her parents are killed in a car crash, and she looks a lot like Helen Hunt. Sean Means is nodding in agreement there. Lily Sobieski, number one. Number two, Barbara Hale. Della Street in the television series Perry Mason. She also has several successful movies, including The Adventure of Lorna Doone, the comedy The Jackpot, a drama A Lion is in the Streets, and The Oklahoman. She's in an anti-war film called The Boy with Green Hair about a war orphan whose hair turns green. Number two, Barbara Hale. Number three, Yasmeen Bleeth. Her television roles include Caroline Holden on Baywatch, Ryan Finelli on Ryan's Hope, Leanne Demarest in One Life to Live. Bleeth has also played the role of Inspector Caitlin Cross on Nash Bridges. She played an orphaned girl in Hey Babe, starring Buddy Hackett. I'll have to go see that. Number three, Yasmeen Bleeth. And number four, Nancy Travis, starred in many films, including Internal Affairs, Air America, Passed Away, Chaplin, So I Married an Axe Murderer, Greedy and Fluke. She plays a mother who dies in a car crash, orphaning her young son in the movie called Bogus, Nancy Travis. Those are the four actors. Can you tell us which one of them is no longer with us?
I'm going to go with number two.
Number two, Barbara Hale, you're right. She died in 2017 at the age of 94, so she had a good run.
Della was the secretary. Drake sat at the desk with Perry.
Frank! Were you a singer in your previous life?
Oh, no, not at all.
Oh, okay.
I just know the words to TV theme songs.
Let's see. Lily Sobieski, she's only 40. She's fine. Yasmeen Bleeth, she's not really fine, but she's still alive. She's 55.
I'll happily check on Yasmeen.
Yeah, look up a current photo of Yasmeen. Right. She's not doing so well. Nancy Travis, 62, and is fine, just fine. So there you go. You have won those tickets to see 21 Pilots August 18th at the Delta Center. Hang on the line, and Katie will get some information from you.
All right, well, I'm sure he's fine, but I got to go check on Ed O'Neill. 78 today.
Oh, he's hardy.
He's hardy. He's fine. Loaded, too, apparently.
Oh, really?
Oh, that's what I hear. Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye.
Bye, Frank. Friend of the program says the road from Logan all the way to West Valley has been excellent. Few cops, minimal traffic accidents. That's a comprehensive traffic report from our Infinity team.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for that. We do have a crash southbound I-215 West, exit ramp to go eastbound I-80, milepost 22. And stalled vehicle eastbound I-80. This is near Lambs Canyon, milepost 136. It's closed the right lane of traffic there. Do you owe $10,000 or more on back taxes, multiple unfiled years? Contact the IRS experts McClure and Stewart for a free consultation. Go to McClureandStewart.com today.
All right, KXRK Provo, we will take a short break and be right back. Sean Means is here to review movies, including Civil War. Stand by.
Even though Radio from Hell is the show for people who've...
Speak a language all their own. It's a language that's often confusing and even incomprehensible to newcomers here in the Beehive State. So, Radio from Hell presents a handy guide to help everyone understand how the natives speak. It's the Utah word of the day, and today's word is
Shurvut. S-H-U-R-V-U-T. Shurvut. Now here to use this somewhat tricky word in dialogue is the mayor of Mona, Utah, Don Criddle, and his son, Denver Criddle. The mayor has called Denver to his office, a tough shed behind the Criddle home, for a somewhat confrontational meeting with his son. Again, the word is shurvut.
Daddy, why have you asked me to come to the office, Daddy? You don't ever invite me to the office of mayor unless there's something I've done wrong or the garbage needs to be took out. Did I do something wrong, Daddy? Or is your garbage can full?
Sit down, son. I want to read you something I seen in the news.
It's from Nephi City.
Nephi City. Oh, those dirty low-down you-know-whats. How much more are we going to take from them, Daddy? Are they trying to steal something away from Mona again? Are they trying to steal away another business from us?
Denver, you are letting it get away from you, son. Just calm down.
Calm down, Daddy. Nephi would love to see Mona dry up and blow away. You know the Maverick down there. They was thinking about locating here in Mona. But the Nephi Council promised them the moon, and they went there.
They went to the moon?
No, they went to Nephi. Oh. And heck, Daddy, Nephi already had a pilot travel center. Yeah. It's war, Daddy. This is a Nephi-Mona war.
Denver, I have told you before, we are not to war with Nephi. Mm. That war is all in your overactive imagination.
Mm.
The whole Maverick thing is just business, son, not war.
It's war, old man, and that's going to change when I'm mayor.
What's that?
Nothing, Daddy, nothing. Why did you want to see me?
Well, when I seen in the news, it was from Nephi City Police, and they want the public's help finding whosomever was responsible for dumping a load of cow manure in a car up to Nephi. They're calling it Manure-ageddon.
Manure-ageddon? Daddy, I don't know nothing about that.
The police say a reward is being offered for the arrest and conviction of those responsible for the manure attack. Now, look. Here's a picture of the car, and a picture of the manure, and a picture of the manure in the car, and a phone number if you have information or want to turn yourself in.
Well, I didn't do nothing, Daddy.
You sure of it?
I'm sure of it. Hey, Daddy, would I get a reward if I turned myself in?
Join us again some other time as we examine how the Utah natives speak with the Utah Word of the Day.
And that's how that goes.
Yeah, like Heather in Springville did.
Springville?
Yeah, she texted from Springville.
All right. Well, Sean Means, Movie Reviews, brought to you by...
X96 welcomes Nightmare on 13th. Return for the one-night-only screen break April 13th. You can listen to Todd Newcomb all week long for your chance to win tickets. For contest details and ticket links, go to x96.com.
All right, thank you. Oh, come on now. There we go. Sean Means is here. MovieCricket.net. Mm-hmm. And of course, you can read all of his stuff in the Tribune, Salt Lake Tribune. And I'm looking at the list today. There's three movies.
Mm-hmm.
But we have quite an occurrence coming up.
Mm-hmm. An occurrence?
An occurrence.
Oh.
The rare sighting.
Oh, really? Oh,
right there. Mm-hmm. So, all right, well, let's begin.
Okay, well, we can also talk about the one really good one that you guys missed when you were gone last week.
Oh, what was that?
Monkey Man.
Monkey Man,
oh, this
was
is
that
Dev,
good?
Dev yes. Patel, right?
Dev Patel. This is an action movie with some of the same DNA as John Wick. You get, definitely get a John Wick feel. But it's more than that. You have this young man in India who wants revenge on a police captain for reasons. You'll find out.
Yeah.
He gets a shot, and there's a fight scene that's really strong, but it's not the end because the fight doesn't end with resolution. So
of course.
He has to come back later. And then there's training scenes and stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, and you get to see Dev Patel with the shirt off. So, yeah.
Okay.
This is the one that Dev Patel put together. It was just going to go to streaming you know, straight to whatever. And who saw it?
Jordan Peele saw it and said, you should put this in theaters, and I'll put my name on it if you like, if that'll help. And
it did.
It did. It did okay. It did okay at the box office first weekend.
Uh-huh.
But Dev Patel directed this, co-wrote it, and started it. And it's, I mean, he's got good acting. He's we know he's a good actor, but he's got a good directing chops here, too.
Well,
good with the fight scenes. He also knows that you need more than a good fight. You need stakes.
Yes.
You know, you need and the drama part. He's really good with that. So,
what'd you give it?
3.5.
3.5.
Oh,
and
Monkey Man.
It opened last week. It's still around. So go find it.
All right.
It deserves some love.
Escape from Germany.
Escape from Germany. This is the latest from the Utah director cinematographer T.C. Christensen. If you like movies about Latter-day Saints, T.C. is your guy.
I guess so.
This is based on a true story about the effort to get Latter-day Saint missionaries out of Germany in 1939, just before the invasion of Poland. And it starts with a missionary who's sent to the U.S. consulate to deliver the message that Heber J. Grant, the church president, knows that the invasion is going to happen any day now.
Oh.
And the consulate's like, well, our military guys are saying it's not going to happen. And the missionary says, well, Heber J. Grant's a prophet, so his sources are better than yours.
Oh, really? Okay, well.
So, yeah, it's that kind of movie.
All right.
Much of the story revolves around this one missionary who's sent to round up the other missionaries and get them on trains to Belgium or Denmark before the Germans close the borders. Fairly tense, well-paced stuff. Mm-hmm. The problem with I love T.C. dearly, but a lot of his movies, these Latter-day Saint movies, is that every coincidence or plot shift is seen as a sign of God's hand at work, right?
Yeah.
And that can get pretty predictable. Miracles are great for sermons, but they're really bad for screenwriting. You know, they take a lot of the tension out of it.
My wife feels the same way about Doctor Strange. Mm-hmm. Magic is cheating.
Magic is
is that what she says?
Yes.
Very similar. Very similar. They filmed this in Budapest and in Utah. They get a lot out of very little money. Mm-hmm. It's very cool how they make the Heber Valley Railroad look like a European train.
Okay.
Two
and a half for Escape from Germany.
And it's playing at all over the state.
I'm sure it is.
Yeah.
La Chimera.
This is an Italian movie with a British actor in the middle. Josh O'Connor, who played the young Prince Charles on The Crown.
Okay.
You're about to see him playing tennis and making out with Zendaya in Challengers.
Oh, okay.
He's in that movie coming up in a couple weeks. So he's on a train to Tuscany, and he apparently just got out of prison for reasons. Again, you find out as you go. He's visiting his old benefactor, Signora Flora, played by Isabella Rossellini.
All right.
She lives in this drafty old mansion that's falling apart. And there's a young woman there. Her name is Italia. And she's taking singing lessons from Flora, but she's also acting as her maid. And they seem to hit it off. But the guy is reunited with his old gang, and soon they're back to the action that we think put him in jail. They are Tomboroli.
Mm-hmm. Tomb raiders?
Grave robbers.
Grave robbers?
They find all the Etruscan tombs and get the pottery and the other goods, and they sell them. And our guy isn't in it for the money. He's looking for something in his life to fulfill him. To make up for a lost love, the one that got away. Mm-hmm. There's all kinds of stuff. This is a very vibrant, sort of messy movie. It's fully engaged in this guy and this gang of Tomboroli and what might happen with him and Italia, the girl, if he can stop living in the past and get into the present.
Okay.
I think it's really beautiful. Mm-hmm. It's really smart. 3.5 stars.
Oh, you like that one.
And it's at the Broadway because you got to read it because it's partly in Italian.
All right.
I mean, Gina doesn't. She knows. She's fluent.
Of course.
At home, that's all we speak.
It's the home. It's it's the home country.
It's the mother tongue.
It's the mother tongue. Exactly.
Let's see. So let's get to Civil War.
Yes. Okay. Civil War. Now the ads let you know what you think this movie is about, which is that part of the United States has seceded from the Union, and is fighting the other part of the U.S. And that is what's happening in this movie. Mm-hmm. But that's not where it's going, and In some ways, that's just the setup.
Okay.
The important stuff is that when we start the movie, the war is going. It's well underway.
It's okay.
And we don't really know what has precipitated this.
We'll get into this in a second.
All right.
But let me explain the setup. So we see the war through a group of war journalists.
Okay. And so that's Reese Witherspoon.
Kirsten Dunst.
Get them mixed
very,
up.
Very different people.
Yes.
They're a special breed of reporters and photographers. They want to go where the action is, whether it's Afghanistan or Ukraine, wherever, mm-hmm. you know. And now that the action is here, in a place where they can all read the street signs, you know, mm-hmm. and it's the same in the language they know, you know, it's different for them. And we start with Lee, that's the Kirsten Dunst character. She's a war photographer who's been at this for a long time,
mm-hmm.
and it's amazing performance. This is like a career best performance.
Really? And she's had some good ones.
She gets really deep into the mindset of this jaded, war-weary journalist, and then what it takes to get her back to caring about what's going on around her. So Lee and her reporting partner, Joel, played by Wagner Moura, they have this plan to drive from New York to Washington to interview the president. Now, to get there, they essentially have to drive through the disputed territory of Pennsylvania, West Virginia, so on.
Mm-hmm.
And each stop, they encounter something different, mm-hmm. and something, you know, showing how the war is actually happening in front of them. So they load up their SUV, press is painted on the side, and they have two journalists going with them. One is Sam, mm-hmm. played by Stephen McKinley Henderson, a great character actor. He was in Dune.
Yeah.
You know.
Older guy.
You know, old reporter. And, you know, and they worry, you know, he's going to slow them down if, you know, mm-hmm. they come under fire. The other is this young reporter, Jesse, played by Kaylee Spaney.
Oh, okay.
Kaylee Spaney. She starred in Priscilla.
Yes.
She played Priscilla Presley. She's a rookie photographer, never been in a war zone before, but she idolizes Lee. And after some hesitation, Lee tries to give her some pointers about, you know, how to do this job. So the cool thing here is that the movie never says how the Civil War started. We don't get to choose sides.
Okay.
We're told the secessionists are from Texas and California. So a red state.
Which is weird. You wouldn't think they would be on the same side.
A red state and a blue state. Right. Big ones.
Not connected.
Right.
Either. Yeah.
And the president is played by Nick Offerman. Thank you for the lead-in, by the way.
I'd vote for him, by the way.
Well, see, when you watch him, you can watch him in this performance, and you could think he's channeling Biden, or you can think he's channeling Trump.
Hmm.
And that's more about you than it's about him, really.
Really?
And there's never any policy statement or anything that says why, you know, just other than the sort of vague platitudes of, you know, we are the United States, blah, blah, blah.
So it's almost like a Rorschach test.
It is. Because what the movie is really about is how war changes the place where it happens and the people it happens to.
Okay.
And it changes the reporters who have seen the war, but it's a new thing when it's in the place where you live, mm-hmm. where you're from. And like I said, Kirsten Dunst really makes this work. It's the best performance of her career. She gets the jaded 1,000-yard stare.
I've seen in the trailers that this is not a typical performance from her.
But she also warms up again in the scenes with Kaylee Spaney, which are really powerful. The sort of, you know, mentor protege thing that happens with them. And Spaney, you know, like I said, you know, we saw Priscilla last year. We're mm-hmm. seeing this. She's the real deal. She's the next generation.
Okay.
Yes, 4 stars.
The rare 4-star.
Wow.
The increasingly not so rare.
Well,
4 stars.
You don't give them much.
I'll say that. I do. Keep my powder dry. Yes.
4 stars for Civil War.
Yep. And it's playing out. It's playing all over the place.
Wow. You see this movie just.
I don't know if I want to see it. Is it going to make me?
This is something actually. The discussion I had with my wife. She didn't want to come along to the screening because she's like, I could watch this on the news.
Yeah.
But there is that feeling of we're looking at what's going to happen 5 years from now, maybe, you know, if things continue to go bad.
Yeah.
But really it's more about what's happening now than it is about what's going to happen. I mean, it has the veneer of being a cautionary predictive thing, mm-hmm. but it's really more about the splits that are mm-hmm. happening right now.
Yeah. See, things that could happen in real life scare me more than a horror movie.
Yeah.
For example,
you know,
John Hamm in that Fargo series.
Yeah. That's real.
He scared the hell out of me because those guys exist.
Yeah.
You know, we're in mm-hmm. this situation. Yeah. This could happen,
mm-hmm.
you know, so that scares me.
Yep.
I don't know. I think I want to go, but I don't. Anyway, 4 stars. What do we got next week, Sean?
Next week, we have the Ministry of Ungentlemanly Warfare. Which sounds like
Henry Cavill,
yeah. Guy Ritchie action movie about mm-hmm. a group of spies during World War II doing crazy stuff. Ministry of Ungentlemanly Warfare sounds like the spoof version, the spoof Wes Anderson version of an action movie.
Exactly.
But this is supposedly also based on a true
on true story about like spies who did, you know, stuff during World War II.
All right.
We also have Abigail, mm-hmm. which is a good old fashioned horror movie. We have a crew going into a mansion to rob it, but they find a little girl in a tutu inside and then find out, oh, she's a vampire.
You know,
like you do. Yeah. And then next week on Netflix, we have Rebel Moon, The Scar Giver. This is part two of the Zack Snyder. I'm gonna make my own Star Wars.
I got 45 minutes into the first one and I stopped.
Oh no.
The first one came out in December and Netflix just pushed the heck out of it, right? And they put it in theaters and everything. Yeah, they're not doing that this time.
They're not doing that with us.
They're doing their contractual obligation and getting the heck out of there. Yep,
the people have spoken.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you, Sean Means. All right. Traffic, please, Gina.
Okay. Let me check our message stream, see if Infiniteam has assembled to give us any traffic updates. Nothing there, but please, if you see something, let us know. Text it to us, 33986. There's a crash on the connector ramp from I-215 southbound to go eastbound I-80 near the airport. The right shoulder is blocked. Disabled semi eastbound I-80 heading up the hill from Lambs Canyon toward the summit of Parley's. The right lane and shoulder are blocked there. And like I said, if you're seeing anything, please text it in and let us know, 33986.
All right, boner of the day coming up. What do we have?
Boner candidate number one, sports builds character.
Okay.
Boner candidate number two, the COVID vaccine gave OJ cancer. And boner candidate number three, JK, you're ruining Harry Potter for me.
All right, boners, big boy news all coming up. Stand by for all of that. Larson HVAC.
Oh, I love these guys. And they love us, by the way. Yes. They're big friends of the program at Larson HVAC. Mm-hmm. Do you have it, Carrie? Because I do.
Oh, it's right here. Yeah.
Thank you. I mean, I can certainly talk about them because they came to my house and they took out my old water heater and put in that on-demand hot water system, which
you like
great.
That?
I love it.
And there's always hot water?
Always hot water. You don't run out if you're running the dishwasher and taking a shower at the same time.
Really?
It's great.
All right.
Convinced
me.
And then they also have, you can enjoy great tasting clean water right from your tap with a new reverse osmosis water system from Larson HVAC and Plumbing. Or you can upgrade your showers, save money on your energy bills with a high-efficiency water heater. And throughout April, you can enter to win one of these systems. Just go to LarsonHVAC.com/X96 and learn how you can enter to win a new reverse osmosis water system or a high-efficiency water heater. That's LarsonHVAC.com/X96.
So how strong was the odor?
So I got out of my car here at the Broadway Media Tower this morning.
Today.
And there's not that many cars down there.
No.
Except Carrie's car is there. And I opened my door and I instantly smelled skunk.
Mm.
Now, I don't think there was a skunk in the parking garage.
Is there a skunk in your car, Carrie?
But I instantly thought... and I asked, as I walked in the studio, I said, Carrie, did you hit a skunk on the way to work? And you said...
I said, well, that answers my question. I didn't hit a skunk.
You didn't hit him?
No.
Mm.
What?
What?
Come in, Katie, I can't...
You can't...
Yeah, you're bad at pantomime.
So you didn't hit a skunk.
I did not hit a skunk. But here's the thing. Yes, Katie.
Are you talking about on the freeway?
It may be. We come in the same...
Because it's on my car, too.
Really?
What happened?
I think somebody hit a skunk on the freeway on our off ramp that you and I normally take, the ninth south off ramp. I think somebody hit a skunk on there because I think I ran over the dead carcass, and now the side of my car smells like skunk, and it covered the entire inside of my car.
Okay. You both ran over it or were near it?
I didn't run over anything. See, what happened was is I was taking that route.
Mm-hmm.
I smelled the skunk,
mm-hmm.
and I'm like, oh, somebody must have hit a skunk, mm-hmm. and that's what I'm smelling.
Yeah.
And then as I proceeded into town, it didn't go away. I thought, well, it's just still circulating in my car.
It was on
and
your
then
car.
I get out, and I'm like, I can still smell it. It must be stuck in my nose is what I'm thinking.
Literally, I've been dealing with my nose inside the studio. Mm. It's because of that. Because
me, I still feel like I smell it.
Exactly, me too.
When I was at Bear Lake one time, mm-hmm. Driving, and a skunk ran right in front of my car, and I ran over it. I killed it. And my car just reeked of skunk. But it goes away pretty fast. You park it outside. Yeah, it should be parked outside now, you know. And
well, it's in the garage.
But it went away pretty, I think it, you know, within a day it went away.
It must have been freshly hit.
This says a skunk smell can last on a car for 2 to 3 weeks.
Oh.
Well, it didn't on mine. I wouldn't have been able to stand it.
How do you clean skunk off a car? Here you go. This
thank
is
you,
for
please.
Both of
you.
How do you clean skunk off a car?
We're going to need this.
Tomato juice, right?
Nope.
Oh.
Distilled vinegar and water equal parts.
Okay.
And dishwashing liquid.
All
mixed together?
All mixed together. Liberally spray the exterior of your car, pay special attention to the undercarriage and the tires.
That's where it...
Great.
Leave it on for 5 minutes, then rinse thoroughly. Repeat if necessary.
What if I take it to one of these fancy car wash
places?
That's
exactly my thought, too.
I think that'll...
And I'll tell them.
Yeah.
Skunk, what can you
that'll do?
Do
it. Help.
You know, maybe they have something.
That'll just run it through that. It'll do it.
Yeah. I was going to bring that up this morning when I came in, and I totally spaced it. But even Vax was, like, pawing at his nose in the car, and I felt so bad because it must have been super freshly hit.
Probably.
If there was a cloud of it sticking in the air, well, to your car and to mine.
But I'm sure it didn't stay on my car all that long, and I ran over it.
You ran yours over.
Yeah.
So. Yeah, see, I think I just passed through, or...
Isn't that interesting that it can be that you didn't hit it, just passing through a cloud of it would carry it all the way.
And it may have been some of the, you know, because when they get hit, they get squashed.
And it spreads.
And the sack spreads, and so the sack probably spread it all over the road.
That's what I'm thinking,
and
too.
And I'm betting that's what happened.
Now, you guys are all concerned about your damn cars. Could we just have a moment, please, for the poor skunk?
Hey, I think skunks are pretty cute. I would own one if I didn't have to deal with the smell. And well, I know you can get it removed, but my husband won't allow me to do that as much as I would love to.
I don't blame him.
They're cute. They're really cute, I think.
Cement Dave says, I've made first contact with both skunks and raccoons. Mm. The raccoon smell lingered longer than the skunk.
Interesting.
But you know what the worst stink that I've ever experienced was? It was during the summer. It was when we lived in Draper. And my car hit a bird I didn't know, and the bird got wedged into the grill.
Oh man.
And then I parked the car over the weekend, and it was hot.
No.
It was summertime. And then I go out there Monday, and it's like, and I couldn't find it. And it was coming in through the vents and everything.
What did you do?
So I had to, you know, sit down and look and dig and take the thing apart, and sure enough, there it was.
Yeah.
I'm glad I'm not the only one that dealt with this smell this morning, because it's bad.
Okay, well, that answers my question. No, I didn't hit a skunk. I just kind of passed through.
You must have passed through right after it was hit, because even mine smells terrible, and I could hear back.
Now, the old, when people, you know, would get hit, sprayed with a skunk, the old cure for that or remedy for that was you're supposed to take a bath in tomato juice.
I remember that.
But I think that's bunk. But that's what
is that one of those old wives' tales?
I think so.
They did it on Seinfeld.
They did.
Well, it must be true.
that it must be a lie.
Seinfeld doesn't lie.
yes, they do all the time. It's quite amazing what they.
It's such a strong smell.
Yeah, and they're you know, raccoons stink, and I knew people who've had pet ferrets. They don't. They don't have a.
They're not
spray,
no.
But they smell gamey.
If you don't take care of the ferrets, they do smell. I used to have two of them when I was a kid.
Well, didn't they always have that kind of smell?
Not if you take care of them.
When you say take care of them, what is that?
You bathe them on a regular basis, like normal. You actually clean out their cage properly. Mm-hmm.
How do you bathe a ferret?
You put them in a bathtub.
They
love it.
Oh, they're okay.
My at least my ferrets absolutely loved playing in the water. You put a little a couple toys in there. There's ferret shampoo.
Wait, there is ferret shampoo.
There's a picture of a ferret on the label. That's how you know.
I loved my ferrets. They were cute.
I've been around them a couple of times. The ones I've been around were actually very friendly.
On this day. In 1983, mm-hmm. REM released their debut studio album, Murmur, with Radio Free Europe, Perfect Circle, Sitting Still, and that song, Talk About the Passion.
I haven't heard that in a while. Thank you.
First album, and you hear that and you go, wow, that's good.
Mm-hmm. I hope they do more. And they did.
They did. All right. Time now for Boner of the Day. Three news stories. These will be examples of bad, stupid, or funny human behavior. And you will decide with your vote of these three candidates, which one is the worst, which one deserves to be Boner of the Day for today, April 12, 2024. We'll give you two candidates now, a third after the news. Once you've heard all three, then you will vote. One of you lucky random boner voters will receive.
I can't buy it. Gotta win it. Radio from Hell Boner t-shirt. Boner candidate number one, sports builds character. A family has filed a $1.5 million lawsuit against a Texas school district, including its superintendent and athletic director,
after a group of football players put peanuts in a peanut-allergic teammate's locker last year. In the lawsuit that was filed on April 6th, the family alleges the players knew the teen was severely allergic to peanuts, and the school district failed to take any action to prevent bullying against their son. Lawsuit also gives more details about the October 6th incident inside the locker room. The family alleges two students scattered peanuts throughout their son's locker and recorded the act, and one of the players threw peanuts at him. The teen allegedly told his teammates that putting peanuts in his locker and on his uniform could result in his death, and he showed them the EpiPen he carries as a precaution. When he retrieved his uniform, he found it along with his cleats covered in peanuts, which triggered an allergic reaction. Now, he didn't ingest the peanuts or wear the contaminated uniform, so he didn't require emergency medical treatment. But he said to them, look, I am allergic to peanuts. Here's my EpiPen. Yeah. I could die.
Please, please, please don't.
So from there to, you know what, it would be funny if we put peanuts all over his stuff.
Guy in the chat room says, sounds like attempted murder.
I mean, yeah, if he said it, I could die. The suit also claims the student's mother met with high school assistant principal days after the incident and was told that any disciplinary action would be handled by the athletic director.
Oh, great.
According to district officials, it launched a bullying investigation after a school board meeting. And it says, bullying is an act or pattern of acts that physically harms a student or materially disrupts the educational process. But they didn't do much to these kids. So the parents said, fine, we're going to sue the school. Boner candidate number one, sports builds character. Boner candidate number two, you know, OJ, he died of cancer because he got the COVID vaccine and it gave him cancer.
No.
News of OJ Simpson passing away has sparked a wave of unfounded conspiracy theories that his death was caused by the COVID-19 vaccine.
Of course.
You can actually, x96.com/live, you can see OJ getting the vaccine. There's a picture of him getting it. In a post shared on Twitter Thursday, the former NFL player's family and presumed murderer announced that he died, also disclosing the cause. Quote, on April 10th, our father, Orenthal James Simpson, succumbed to his battle with cancer, the post read. During this time of transition, his family asked you to please respect their wishes for privacy and grace. Simpson's death announcement was met with mixed public reaction. It wasn't mixed. Nobody was sad about that.
Nobody was.
Simpson's controversies became a talking point on social media because there was an immediate wave of cynicism from a number of vaccine skeptics.
Of course.
Claims that COVID-19 vaccines cause health problems or increased chances of death. So they love it when a celebrity that publicly got vaccinated dies.
Yeah.
And it does not matter what they die from.
No, it doesn't. It's because they got the shot.
Yeah. They point to, many anti-vaccination activists have attempted to link deaths among athletes in particular. Mm-hmm. Looking at you, John Stockton. Other notable figures being vaccinated, especially those who otherwise appeared healthy before they died.
Mm-hmm.
The phrase suddenly died has become a dog whistle for such assertions.
I'm trying to find it right now. There was a report released yesterday. Here it is. A new study that says it finds COVID vaccines had nothing to do with young adults dying suddenly from heart failure.
No.
They've done a complete study, and they said, no, that's not why they died of heart failure.
No.
It's not the vaccine. And that was just yesterday. So it doesn't give you cancer.
No. And you'll see the phrase turbo cancer. Have you seen that?
No.
So that's what they're saying. These super healthy people all of a sudden get cancer really quick and died. It's turbo cancer. If you see that phrase, turbo cancer, that's anti-vax stuff.
Stay away from that. Yeah. Luckily, I'm not on that part of the web.
Yeah.
So I don't see that stuff too often. But.
So boner candidate number two. The COVID vaccine, that's what gave OJ cancer.
Yep.
Coming up in a moment, boner candidate number three. JK, you're just still ruining Harry Potter for me.
Boner candidate number three coming up after this. Big boy news and opinuendo brought to you by.
Become a nurse in just 32 months at Nightingale College, blending online classes with on-ground supervised field experience. Virtual college, actual nursing. Start your nursing journey at nightingale.edu. Now accepting enrollment for summer semester. Shohei Ohtani's former interpreter has been charged with a felony after federal prosecutors say they discovered he stole nearly $20 million from the Major League Baseball superstar, in part to pay off his massive gambling debts. United States Department of Justice announced the filing, saying at a news conference in Los Angeles on Thursday that they were hitting him with one count of bank fraud. Prosecutors say he faces a maximum of 30 years in prison if convicted. During an investigation, it was revealed that he had stolen from Ohtani. So he's his interpreter.
Yeah.
He was able to access funds via an account he helped the player set up back in 2018. Because I'm your interpreter.
Let me help you.
Yeah, let me. Yeah. I can read this English on this bank account for you.
Let me take care of this.
Now, apparently he had a bunch of gambling debt. He was trying to. So when you saw these headlines of Ohtani, interpreter, gambling, I think people thought, is Ohtani in on this and he's throwing games? He was not involved in it at all. He's a victim here. He was stolen from. He didn't do anything wrong.
And I guess the interpreter had some sort of system set up where he pretended to be Ohtani.
Yeah, well, because he would speak for him all the time.
And also that it was like a bet would automatically go out once an hour.
Mm-hmm.
He had it set up
an
to do that.
An automated thing, yeah.
Automated,
mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We were just talking with Sean Means off the air, actually. He was talking about how CinemaCon. There's a couple of things that came out of that. Keanu Reeves' hard luck hitman, John Wick, seemed to suffer a rather permanent fate that would likely keep him out of future franchise installments. But
nobody dies in comic books.
You can't keep that guy down. When last seen in 2023's John Wick Chapter 4, spoiler alert, the beloved action movie assassin, it's pretty clear he died in that. Well, there is a spinoff called John Wick Presents Ballerina, starring Ana de Armas. It's supposed to be in theaters.
I like her.
Yeah, she was nominated for an Academy Award for, she played Marilyn Monroe.
Mm-hmm.
Should be coming out June 6th. In the explosive first trailer for Ballerina, the new face of vengeance, that's De Armas, is seeking retribution for those who killed her family. And she wants help. I need to train for this. How do I become an assassin? Well, you see Keanu Reeves pop up to train her.
Now, is this a prequel?
They're not saying. Probably.
I'll bet it's a
probably.
Prequel. Yeah.
But you get to see John Wick again.
You get to see him. Of course. We knew we'd see him again.
So.
Apparently at CinemaCon they showed 7 minutes of Deadpool and Wolverine.
That's a lot.
And Kevin Feige was there dropping F-bombs from the stage to assure everybody we're staying true to the character. All right?
reactions are in after the first footage of Ridley Scott's Gladiator sequel.
Oh, yes.
Starring Paul Mescal aired behind closed doors at CinemaCon on Thursday. Scott's highly anticipated follow-up to the 2000 classic starring Russell Crowe will tell the story of Lucius, son of Lucilla. That was the Connie Nielsen character.
Mm-hmm.
And Crowe's Maximus, who came to his demise. Spoiler alert, he dies at the end of Gladiator. Mm-hmm. But it's got good reactions.
Oh, good.
People are saying it could even be better than Gladiator. And I liked Gladiator. I thought that was...
Another announcement that was made at CinemaCon is that they're going to make a live-action Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles movie rated R.
Oh, Katie's happy about rated R.
Rated R for the grown-ups. It's based on a comic book that's out right now, slowly coming out, called The Last Ronin, and the story is...
Katie's raving about it.
And there's a video game coming as well, but it's about Michelangelo is the last living turtle.
Okay.
And he is on a trip of vengeance to finally destroy Shredder and kill him.
And it kind of makes sense that it would be rated R because, I mean, there are kids that like Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles now, but it's also people our age that were...
I mean, that's who it was intended for originally. It was, believe it or not, a parody of Frank Miller's Daredevil. because they were fighting instead of the hand, which was Daredevil, he mm-hmm. kept fighting this clan of ninjas, the hand, theirs was the foot, you know, and it was funny.
Get it? Yeah.
But it was originally not for kids, but it was, you know, the toy company bought it and said, let's make a cartoon, let's make it for kids, and it's known for.
You're going to hear crap about that, I'm sure.
Oh, absolutely, yeah.
Immediately after Monday's solar eclipse, the number of people searching Google for eye-related injuries jumped. It was trending. I think Stephen Colbert had a bit on it. My eyes hurt was trending on on Google. And apparently there was a surge in people going to eye doctors saying, oh no, my eyes hurt. I looked. Mm-hmm. I shouldn't have looked, but I looked. It just don't. People are having permanent damage from that.
Mm-hmm.
At least we have a while before the next eclipse. You can practice not looking at the sun.
I'm practicing not looking at
the sun. I'm doing it right now.
Very good.
You're going to have to help me with time, Carrie Jackson.
one more story.
Okay, we have... McDonald's restaurants in the Netherlands have debuted a revolutionary way to turn consumers on to their iconic burgers and fries. They're launching the world's first billboard that smells like their food. It's the first time a billboard's been used to diffuse a McDonald's scent, the Golden Arches rep described. At first glance, the logo-free red and yellow billboards were installed to evoke sculptures of some minimalist modern art movement. Can't tell it's McDonald's. But then as you walk by,
mm-hmm.
you can smell French fries. They apparently have a fan on it that blows.
See, that was my question, is how do you...
It's like when you go to the mall and you smell those cinnamon roasted nuts that they do. And they kind of blow
okay,
the scent.
All right. Okay.
You know, you just drive by a McDonald's and you can smell that. I don't know if
I never do.
You never drive...
I never smell it when I drive by a McDonald's.
I don't know if this will work. We'll have to see. Let's see. Weather. Today will be, I'm just going to go ahead and say 80. They're predicting 79. Let's just pretend it'll be 80 because it's going to be very, very warm today and sunny. You think I'm pushing it?
Your ass is writing checks that it can't cash. Is that the saying? Anyway.
My mouth is writing checks that I don't know. Anyway, quite warm and sunny today. Actually, beautiful weekend, all weekend long, sunny and warm. Next chance for rain looks like Sunday into Monday, and things cool back off into the low 60s and overnight lows in the 40s. So we get back down into that. Traffic, let me refresh this, see what the latest is. And I need your help with traffic today, folks. Infiniteam needs to assemble. Crash at the bottom of the exit ramp, northbound I-15 to 24th Street in Ogden. The right shoulder of the exit ramp blocked. Power also appears to be out in the intersection, so police are directing traffic there. Let me check. But you certainly can if you see something. Please let us know at 33986.
All right.
Voter candidate number 3 is JK. You're still ruining Harry Potter for me.
You know, and she doesn't care.
I don't know why she's commented on this at all, ever.
She's got all the money. She doesn't care.
J.K. Rowling is not on good terms with the Harry Potter cast, who have opposed her anti-transgender views. Mm-hmm. Responding to a post from a fan about, quote, feeling safe in the knowledge that Rowling would forgive Harry Potter stars Daniel Radcliffe and Emma Watson, who have denounced the author's anti-trans rhetoric, Rowling wrote, no, not safe. I'm afraid. They're not safe in the knowledge that she will. So she's not going to forgive. So a while ago, she's come out with these anti-trans statements. And the cast has come out and said,
hey,
that's not right.
Yeah.
Her post continued. Celebs who cozied up to a movement intent on eroding women's hard-won rights, who use their platforms to cheer on the transitioning of minors, can save their apologies for traumatized detransitioners and vulnerable women reliant on single-sex spaces. She's doubling down on this stuff.
She's gone down that internet hole. Yeah.
Rowling penned a personal essay June 2020 detailing her beliefs about trans activism and young people experiencing gender dysphoria, eventually outgrowing them. Several Harry Potter cast members publicly criticized her comments, which were deemed transphobic. Mm-hmm. Quote, this is Rupert Grint, your favorite, Katie. I firmly stand with the trans community and echo the sentiments expressed by many of my peers. Trans women are women, trans men are men. We should all be entitled to live in love without judgment. That's Rupert Grint.
Mm-hmm.
Daniel Radcliffe says transgender women are women. Emma Watson says the same thing. So,
yeah,
she hasn't left well enough alone with this. She just keeps going, and
yep.
I don't know why. Boner candidate number three, J.K., you're ruining Harry Potter for me.
All right, let's review the first two and vote.
Boner candidate number one, Sports Builds character. This is a Texas football team who knew that one of their fellow players had a severe peanut allergy, so much so that he said, I will die if I'm exposed to peanuts. Well, they poured a bunch of peanuts in his locker and rubbed them all over his uniform, because that's funny.
Mm.
Boner candidate number two, the COVID vaccine gave O.J. cancer. These are the conspiracy theories that popped up immediately after O.J. Simpson died yesterday, saying that the vaccine gave him cancer.
Yep.
And boner candidate number three, you just heard it. JK, you're ruining Harry Potter for me.
Time to vote for boner of the day. Here we go. One, two, or three. Which one do you think is the worst? Which one deserves to be boner of the day? One, two, or three. Put your candidate number, the one that you think should win, in the message of a text, and then text that to 33986. All right. That's one way to vote. Another way to vote is to call Katie in the producer's booth at 877-602-9696. She'll take your voice vote. Or go online, x96.com. Look for the box that says Boner of the Day, April 12, 2024. Click and vote. If you don't see that, refresh your browser. It'll appear. Click and vote. Don't forget, as soon as we award Boner of the Day, it's Have Another Drink with Jimmy the Wine Guy. He's here.
We're talking gin.
Oh,
too bad Bill isn't here. He loves gin.
I know.
Yeah, we'll be talking gin, and he'll be answering your questions. So be ready to call in at 8 o'clock with your questions for Jimmy the Wine Guy. Have Another Drink with Jimmy coming up. Stand by. All right. It's Boner of the Day. You've got less than 4 minutes. Let's get to voting.
I have a funny bathroom story.
Okay.
A public bathroom story.
Okay.
And all Bill right. will like this because I tend to attract weirdos in public bathrooms. There was the incident years ago at a truck stop in Panguitch. We won't get into that one.
Oh.
I'll tell you that after. But so I'm going to the Duran Duran show. This is Saturday night, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm at the Delta Center. There's mm-hmm. you know, like 20,000 people. It's sold out. Great show, by the way. Okay. But before Duran Duran goes on, I have to use the men's room, so I go mm-hmm. and take care of my business. I'm at the sink washing my hands, okay? And I see in the mirror a dude kind of looking at me, and I'm like, oh, he probably knows that I'm Todd Newcomb, because you know, mm-hmm. kind of obvious. But I don't think he did. He's like, whoa, you got blue hair, man. It's like a blue Skittle. Yeah, blue Skittle. Yeah, blue Skittle hair. And he's obviously had a couple of beverages, you know. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And I'm just kind of like, yeah, okay, hey, great. And that was it. And I tell my wife that just happened. And mm-hmm. then we go and we watch Duran Duran. So the next night, you're not going to believe this. The next night, it's The Cure. Okay. So we mm-hmm. go to the Delta Center again.
Yeah.
And we're seated on a completely mirror opposite side of the arena.
Okay.
Totally different seats. And before The Cure goes on, and you know, go do my thing in the men's room, and I go in there, and I'm at the sink again, and I'm not even kidding you, the same dude, I look in the really? Mirror, and it's the same guy, whoa, blue Skittle hair, you're here again, woo! And at that point, I high-fived him, we did a one-arm embrace, and I'm like, dude, we gotta hang out. So two nights in a row.
So you made a date with a guy in a bathroom is
yes,
what I'm getting from that.
Apparently I did because of my blue hair. And I'm blue Skittle hair, at least in his book. But that's just the weirdest thing that two nights in a row.
It is odd.
Different crowd of people. I mean, a lot of people were there for both shows, but God, that was bizarre.
I'm surprised he didn't know who you are.
I almost thought of saying, you know,
don't you know who I am?
I was exactly. going to say, yeah, the Bill Allred. But
you would have said,
he
would have said, well, you're Bill Allred.
Yes, and I would have totally owned that. And there you go. So that was weird. I also saw, like, everyone, The Cure, there were more people that I recognized and that I knew and that knew me at The mm-hmm. Cure show.
Than Duran Duran.
I bumped into our buddy Dallin Weeks from I Don't Know How, But They Found Me.
Oh, Dallin was there.
Yeah, he was there with his teenage daughter.
Really?
She was seeing The Cure for the first time, and I thought that was cute.
My offspring went as well and bought a Cure Tour t-shirt.
Yes.
And has been wearing it around town, and practically everywhere they go with my wife, they say, hey, you went to The Cure? How was it? Everybody loves The Cure.
Oh, yeah. And it was a young, like, you had, for The Cure, there were more young people there than Duran Duran by far. We were seated next to a couple of teenage girls, and I kind of leaned over, like, hey, have you ever seen The Cure before? She's like, no, we're new fans. And it was adorable because they knew all the songs. They were singing along to all of them, even mm-hmm. the deep stuff that The Cure played.
Yeah.
And they just had a great time. And I leaned over to one of them because it was when Robert was dancing around during Close to Me. And I says, I just love it when he dances because it's cute, you know, the way Robert awkwardly dances. And she's like, oh, I know, he dances like my Nana.
Wait a minute.
Wears the same makeup.
Wait a minute. Well. Who said that to you?
That was the girls, the teenagers sitting next to us.
Well, that might have been my offspring because they said to me, you know, Robert Smith dances just like Nana.
Really?
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, my wife's mother. He does this kind of...
Well, all right, you'll have to compare notes.
Show me some photos.
Compare notes later. Okay.
All right, 7:48. Let's award boner of the day.
And today's boner is brought to you in part by Penne Arrabbiata, pasta of the angry man.
Well, look at you.
And Gracie's, open daily for lunch and dinner, now serving brunch every Friday, Saturday, Sunday till 3 p.m. Enjoy Gracie's award-winning heated patio, live music four nights a week. Gracie's is located at the corner of 3rd Southwest Temple. Must be 21 or older to enter. Your boner candidates today were boner candidate number one, sports builds character. This is the football team in Texas. The parents of a football player who was being bullied are suing the school district because he said, hey, I'm deathly allergic to peanuts. And the players thought, you know, it'd be funny. Let's try to kill him with peanuts. And they put a bunch of peanuts in his locker. Boner candidate number two was O.J. Simpson died yesterday, and immediately the conspiracy theories start rolling out that, well, he got cancer from the COVID vaccine, yeah. Clearly. He had that turbo cancer.
Turbo.
And boner candidate number three, J.K., you keep ruining Harry Potter for me. This is J.K. Rowling continuing to double down, triple down.
I thought that one would win.
Maybe, well, she's won before for that, so
okay.
Maybe that's why. It's just the fact that she's still going on about it,
mm-hmm.
that her anti-trans comments. But no, that was a distant second place, boner candidate number three. The winner, by far, boner candidate number one, sports builds character.
That surprised me that one won, but there you go. We don't pick them, you do. It's your boner of the day for today, April 12, 2024. Now qualified to be boner of the week. That'll be decided by Dave the Flower Guy. He'll be here at 9:50, just as we leave, to tell us who boner of the week is. Have another drink with Jimmy, brought to you by...
Ransom Spirits is a pioneering, innovative craft distillery that introduced the United States to the first Old Tom Gin and brought the world's first barrel-aged Old Tom Gin in modern history.
Have another drink, it'll make you feel better. Have another drink, and you'll feel all right. If you feel down and you're under the weather, have another drink, and you'll feel all right.
WineAcademyOfUtah.com, Jimmy Santangelo. The Grand Poobah of the Wine Academy. And he can teach you as well.
Now, Jimmy, I think you're a liar today. Because you said you were going to tell us about gin, this Ransom Spirits.
Right.
And you have two bottles here.
Yep.
One of those, that looks like gin to me. That's yeah. clear. And, you know, that looks like gin. The other yeah. one is a lovely caramel color. That does not look like gin to
yeah,
me.
That's the old time. Ransom Spirits, they also make wines, and we're talking today about their spirits in their spirits lineup. They
I've have had vermouth. Their wine, yeah.
Yep. Yeah, their vermouth. Mm-hmm. They have a bourbon. But we're talking about their gin lineup. The old the London Dry or the dry gin that they have here, mm-hmm. the clear one. And then the Old Tom gin that they have. What I love about Ransom Spirits, so Ransom Spirits is out of Sheridan, Oregon, and what they do is they have their fields of grain that they source from. Mm-hmm. And this is one of those true grain-to-glass kind of distilleries where they're using, they know where the grain's coming from. The base spirit on these gins is corn, rye, and even barley. Typically, yeah. gin producers like to have a blank slate of corn that they can then build all the herbs on top uh-huh. of. What Ransom does is they do that same thing. We were reading the list of herbs that uh-huh. go into this in essences, but they also want to have characterful base spirit, which contributes to the overall arcing flavor uh-huh. of this product. It's a really dynamite. It's a premium gin.
Now, the one that's aged in...
Pinot Noir barrels.
Okay. Yep.
So, Old Tom gin is a term in the early 1800s, Prohibition era days, even pre-Prohibition. Mm-hmm. Old Tom was a style of gin where they would transport, rather than bottles, they would transport the gin in barrels, and that's where it gained some of its color along the way.
So it wasn't on purpose. It was just a delivery system?
More of a delivery yeah. system. And the story goes Old Tom was one of those distributors. The second story behind it, and equally as valuable, the pharmacies in the apothecaries, the pharmacies would, because the gin was a bit harsh, mm-hmm. so yeah. they would add in a little bit of sucra, a little bit of sugar, a little bit of that aging to make it softer, more approachable.
Mm-hmm.
This Ransom was the first gin post-prohibition to celebrate old-time gin 25 years ago. And we have it here in our wine stores today. Goes into great Negronis, makes great Martinez cocktails.
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask. Cocktail. Is it different drinks you make with
yeah.
this?
So this one, the Old Tom, the darker, have a little bit of a caramel smell. Mm-hmm. The yeah. herbs still come out. The juniper still comes out. A little mm-hmm. bit of orange zest in there.
It's delicious. I usually don't care about gin a whole lot.
I'm not a gin person. My wife loves gin, but I'd be curious to see what she thinks of this.
Ooh, it's got a nice little pepper yeah. thing going on there
exactly.
as well.
Yeah.
Very spirituous. It's got a lot of... One thing I love about Ransom products, whether it's these gins here that we're showcasing today, the dry gin or the Old Tom, mm-hmm. they're vermouths. Very herbaceous.
Yeah.
The herbs are very much in the forefront, more so than a lot of other gins. Some gins have a lane that they go down. Mm-hmm. This lane is just a bunch of herbs just busting out of the glass aromatically. What a fantastic dry martini. One of my favorite martinis with the London Dry Ransom, using their dry vermouth. Stirring that down, stirring it down, get it nice and cold, straining it into a martini glass, and dropping in a Gibson olive in there.
Ooh.
That olive and the vinegar, you know, that yeah. kind of offsets a little bit. And that's a very proper, for me, that's a real proper dry martini.
For the beginners,
yeah.
The term dry, you're using the term dry a lot. You want to explain that?
Sure. So when you have a dry product on the palate, usually it's going to be a little stronger. It might finish almost bitter on the palate, but dry implies it's not going to be a sweet drink. It's not even going to be an off dry drink. There's no juice involved. There's no vermouth sweetness involved from other components in that cocktail. Mm. And this dry gin that we're having, the clear mm-hmm. one, it goes great with Fever Tree tonic.
It's
gin and tonic on its own. This is yeah. a delicious.
Again, I'm not a gin person, but this is delicious.
Nice.
I'm looking at the label. Here are the herbs they list.
Okay.
Juniper, of course, lemon, coriander, angelica root, caraway, anise, marion berries, orris root. I've never even heard of that. Cardamom, orange. And I also like this. I was reading this on the label, too. Made entirely by hand without the use of computers or robots.
That's right. They don't outsource.
I'm going to get a shirt. I'm going to get a t-shirt with it.
Made entirely by hand without the use of computers or robots.
No, it's true there. Tad Seastad was the original founder of Ransom Gin, and he's a central New York, upstate New York boy like me. I've met him once or twice before here in the market, and super just very, he's a very smart guy, and I love talking with him because he's just so precise and exact. And you can really tell his personality is reflected in the quality of this stuff, of the accuracy, of the authenticity. That's the word I'm thinking of. Mm-hmm. And the sincerity of the herbaceous, of the herbs and the essences. Nobody does a base spirit with corn, rye, barley. Everything's just blank slate, which is also good. There's nothing wrong with doing that. That's a style. But here's a style that's elevated, and it's Ransom Gin.
That's great. All right. Clearly, Jimmy knows his stuff.
Obviously.
Clearly. So it's time for you to call or text. Ask questions of the expert. 877-602-9696 is the number to call. If you're shy or the bishop, text your questions to 33986.
Can be about booze, can be about mixing cocktails.
Restaurant recommendations.
Yeah.
Anything. All of that.
How to celebrate the spring.
Yeah. I want to talk about disco drinks coming up.
Yeah. You got it.
877-602-9696 or 33986 for Jimmy. All right.
Friend of the program says, just witnessed an accident, 54th South eastbound, about 30th West. Thank you, Infiniti member. Another one of you says, eastbound 21st South, bumper to bumper, just past 5600 West. Fender bender or COVID, it's probably COVID.
Probably COVID.
Thank you, whoever sent that in. Let's see. We have this issue up north. Use caution at the intersection of 24th Street, I-15 in Ogden. The exit ramp is blocked. It looks like power is out in that same area as well, so you might need to find an alternate route through there. And if you see anything, please let us know. Text it to us, 33986, and I will pass it along.
All right, KXRK Provo, 877-602-9696 is the number to call to talk to Jimmy, or text your question, 33986.
Opened it up, and inside there's no note or anything. Inside I see a giant package of the Reese's Caramel Big Cups. Now I didn't order this, and I know my husband didn't order
of course
this.
no as a matter of fact, you're hiding it from him, aren't you?
That's why I brought
he never listens to the show.
That's why I brought it to work. But then my very next thought was, I know who sent
your
this.
Son did.
And I sent a picture of it to Festus, my sailor son, and I said, did you do this? And he immediately called me, and he said, I was watching the Super Bowl.
Oh, yeah.
And he said, I thought Carrie and Bill would like these, so would you make sure they get them?
And I don't have their addresses.
And I thought, who would appreciate the Reese's Caramel Big Cup?
Carrie and Bill. So what do you?
So these are the Caramel Big Cups.
They're heavy. That's a good. It's a good 1.4 ounces.
Yeah, this is the candy that eats like a meal.
Well, it's good and solid.
Yeah.
Oh no, I thought it had caramel on top of it because the picture is deceiving.
No, it's like a layer with the peanut butter.
You get a layer inside.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So, I did bring these to work not only to share with you, but also if I have these at home, I will eat all of them, and that's not
so
good.
You'll leave them at your desk and eat all of them
here?
Well,
I'll have a few of them, but I'm sharing them with. And
so there's two gone.
And Katie and Macy, if you guys want one, you can come get one, too.
Interesting.
Do you like it?
Well, it's not as
chewy caramel as I was expecting. It's a caramel-like substance.
It's not gooey. It's no. not like you pull it no. away from your mouth and there's a string.
It's not sticking to your teeth yeah. either.
Which is a good thing.
I think I'd rather have it a little chewy.
Oh, okay. Well, so thank you, Festus. There's a little snack for.
Six.
Yeah, like Heather in Harrisville did.
Harrisville.
Yeah, Heather's got questions about vermouth.
Well, she needs to call or text us.
Call or Heather texted 33986.
All right. But call 877-602-9696 because...
Have another drink, it will make you feel better. Have another drink, it will feel all right.
As brought to you by Rocky Mountain Mixers, your locally owned and operated Mixers and More store, offering Utah's widest selection of mixers in one location, located just east of the Cottonwood Heights Liquor Store on Fort Union, or visit them online at rockymixers.com.
All right, 877-602-9696. Call. Jimmy will take your questions. He knows all. He drinks all.
Only at 8 a.m. on Friday mornings.
That's true.
Here's a good question right off the bat.
All right.
Jimmy, I'm having a bar service for a small 50-person private party. I get to choose two specialty cocktails for them to serve. What are two cocktails I should choose that most people will like?
You know, that's a great question. I would go with a clear spirit, a light spirit, and then a dark spirit, something aged in barrel. Starting on the latter, do a Manhattan cocktail. That's always quite nice. It's quite elegant in a martini glass or otherwise. If you want to have something less strong, maybe do the Brown Derby, which is three parts bourbon, bourbon, 2 parts grapefruit juice, 1 part honey water. That could be made out batched, shaken, and then poured right over a rock in a glass. From the clear spirits, you can be playful there. You could do gin and tonic. That's very
that's easy.
You can do a cosmopolitan. That's always
easy.
Fun. Those are easy, little cranberry and so forth. And then if there's a theme, if you want to tie it into a theme based on the 50-person event, you can get playful from there.
Yeah, there you go. Let's see. Scott is on the phone, and he wants to talk about bourbon.
Mm.
Oh, bourbon.
Oh, bourbon. Scott, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Go ahead.
Yeah, my boy and I are starting to get a nice collection of some bourbon and whiskey, and I was just wondering, can it go bad, you know, if we keep it for too long?
You know how it doesn't go bad if you drink it. It does not go bad in your belly.
Scott, great question. Yeah, it can. What it can do is oxidize. You don't want to keep it in the boot of the car, you know, knocking back and forth in the trunk. You want to keep it in a nice, still ambient temperature that's consistent. What I do is some of my fine scotches, because there's alcohol in there and it will evaporate. Some of my scotches that I bring back from the UK, I'll saran wrap the top, literally, and just keep that spirit in there. Sometimes I'll set them on their side just to keep them rested. So you don't want to have too cold, too hot, too cold, too hot. And one great whiskey bourbon that I'd recommend for you and your boy to enjoy is called Old Elk. And it is available here in the state. They've sponsored us before on the show.
That's good stuff.
It's a high wheat profile of the bourbon, nice and smooth. And it's a father and son collaboration.
All righty. I appreciate it.
See, there you go. Man.
Thanks.
All right. Let's see. Here's a text question. 877-602-9696 if you'd like to ask a question on the phone. Text question. 2 questions. What is a good introduction drink for someone wanting to try gin?
Okay.
Gin and tonic.
Gin and tonic, yeah.
And what are other drinks that use amaretto besides an amaretto sour?
Besides an amaretto sour. Yeah. Sometimes we'll see amaretto in coffee or simply over ice. There is an amaretto flip with egg white, which isn't as sour as the amaretto sour. I'm trying to think of it, amaretto is, you know, it's an interesting liqueur, right? It's got that really strong flavor.
Yeah.
It is great for after dinner. We made a tea. I was just talking about this the other day. We made a tea the other day, collaborated with, it was about 12 years ago, with Tea Grotto, where we collaborated. And we had some of those nice aromatics that reminded us. I think it's still there. It's called Trio. Reminded us of some of those great aromatic flavors that were reflective of amaretto.
That's good. Here's a text question. Jimmy, I love White Claw and hard seltzers.
You really love them? You love them?
Yeah. But sometimes I get tired of the bubbles. I want something similar, low-key, but without bubbles. Is there anything like this that's not hard alcohol?
Right. You know, Riesling, Pinot Grigio, these are white wines without bubbles.
Yeah.
They reflect the same. Excuse me, a little gin and tonic has caught my throat.
Have another drink. It'll make you feel better.
There you go.
And these wines are similar in that they got that slight acidity. They have that fruity flavor. They're dry. They're not sweet. Perhaps that could meet your goal.
And they're canned. They're in cans, too.
Yeah, some of them are in cans.
So
You're absolutely right.
You get that same feeling. let's see. Zane is here. Hello, Zane.
Hey, guys. Hey, Jimmy.
Hey.
Hey, I was wondering where I could get Duff beer.
Yeah, right? And the Simpsons.
I know it's on tap down in Florida.
Oh, it really
no
is?
Kidding.
Yes.
Somebody has made it?
Made Duff beer. It's at Universal Studios. One of those amusement parks has, is it Universal? Thank
That's
you.
That's great.
Has Simpsons Land, and you can get Duff beer on tap there.
Nice. I don't want to go to Florida.
Oh, I don't either. But you asked a question, and I'm answering it. I don't
Fair
think
enough.
It's.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Thanks,
I don't think it's available anywhere.
No.
Oh, in California.
There you go.
Universal they have a Simpsons Land in California as well? Okay, well, then you don't have to go to Florida.
That's close.
I thought it was just in Florida.
We're looking for reasons for you not to go to Florida. So.
Any excuse to not go to Florida. Let's see. Hi, you mentioned vermouth a few times.
Yeah.
Is that a spirit?
So
is it a component of a martini? What is vermouth?
Yeah, so vermouth's a wine base, so you need to make a wine, and then we add sugar to it if we're making an off-dry. A lot of herbs and other components, and then we heat it up. It's called an amaretized wine, mm-hmm. vermouth, and we can make it dry, we can make it sweet. We can make it red. We can make it clear. We can even make one that's off dry that's clear. So vermouth is a type of spirit that was drunk on its own before dinner, after dinner, and now it's a component to a cocktail. Mm-hmm. You would use dry vermouth if you want to have a dry martini. You would use sweet vermouth if you're making something such as the Manhattan that we mentioned earlier or the Martinez, which is the original martini cocktail. So vermouth is... relatively shelf stable. You can they're anywhere from $14 to $30, and they last quite a long time and have a little higher alcohol, about 20% alcohol by volume.
All right, let's talk about some of these events that you've got coming up.
You can learn
from the master in person. And I'm curious about this one tonight.
Tonight at Edison House, disco drinks. We're celebrating cocktails from that era of the 1970s. We have a soundtrack. We're going to be dancing. We're going to be mixing drinks. I'm starting selfishly with the first cocktail I ordered as a little kid at a wedding called the Harvey Wallbanger.
There we go.
And
it's a good radio name if you're looking for a
that's
radio.
That's it, yeah. Sure. Harvey Wallbanger, that we're doing the Blue Hawaiian, which is in that nice hurricane glass. It'll be blue color. We're going to have the umbrellas mm-hmm. in it. And then finishing with a, what the heck are we finishing with? White Russian. Just a nice white Russian. So it's just this very nice arc, talking about the history of each drink, letting you engage with everybody. But everything's about education, you know, mm-hmm. and the yeah. experience of it.
And you've got a lot of classes coming.
Yeah, we got a lot of things coming up. Then next week at the shop, which is a co-working space, Ken Garf U Club, Spring Wine and Small Bite Tasting. Tracy Aviary on April 18th, Thursday, Wine Takes Flight, that we collaborate that with Beehive Cheese. That's really good.
Mm-hmm.
The following Sunday, we're at Clearwater Distillery for a cigar and spirits tasting. Monday, Lifelong Learning, Single Malts Around the World. Mm. Wednesday, on the 24th of this month, Seven Gables, which is over in the Gardener's Village. We're doing a wine and cheese pairing. That's going to be our first tasting there. And then see me at Leonardo Museum on the 25th of this month, celebrating Earth Day with wine.
There you go.
And all of these you can register for and learn more about at...
Yep, wineacademyofutah.com.
Now, my wife has a tip for you.
Oh.
Because you're going to Scotland soon.
I am.
She wants you to get out your next Netflix password or borrow it from us. And there's a show, Somebody Feed Phil is
yes,
the name of the
love
show.
Love Somebody Feed
okay.
Phil.
The
okay.
most recent season, he went to Scotland.
Mm.
Now, when I was in Scotland, you didn't have that much food choice.
You're right.
But now
they even smushed the peas.
Exactly. Mushy peas. He hits several
yeah.
wonderful looking restaurants in Scotland.
It's a lot of fun.
Somebody
yeah.
feed Phil.
Somebody feed Jimmy.
Please.
Thanks guys. Have a good
Thank
weekend.
You. WineAcademyOfUtah.com.
Crash North Bend I-15 5th South, milepost 307. It's off to the left shoulder. Crash eastbound 201 freeway approaching Bangor Highway. Left shoulder affected there. Crash at the bottom of the exit ramp, northbound I-15, 24th Street in Ogden. The right shoulder of the exit ramp blocked. It also appears that the power could be out at that intersection, so police are directing traffic. Might want to avoid that area if you can. And if you see things out there on the roads that need to be avoided, you can text us and let us know. 33986 is where you do that. The State Room presents Don't Miss Neil deGrasse Tyson as he shares his cosmic perspective live on stage at the Eccles Theater Wednesday, April 17th. Get tickets at thestateroompresents.com.
All right. We're going to take a break, play a song, and right after that, it's Beat Gina, 877-602-9696. You can line up to play. You will win what?
Tickets to see Glass Animals Ooh. September 5th at Utah First Credit Union Amphitheater.
Glass Animals tickets at 877-602-9696. You will win It's Andy Garcia's birthday today, but he was in a lot of movies.
Yeah, don't let that discourage you.
Yeah. We got, you know, Ocean's movies and Godfather movies and all that stuff. So, 877-602-9696 for Andy Garcia. For Andy Garcia tickets. For Glass Animals tickets. Sorry. Glass Animals tickets. 877-602-9696. BigOTires.com.
Oh, it's the team you trust, Big mm-hmm. O Tires. I go to the one on Highland Drive.
Now, is it true that you just pull up and say, check my tires?
Yeah. I have done this many times. And a little light, tire light comes on in your car.
Yeah.
Just pull up to Big O. I don't even get out of my car. They come up and I say, hey, my tire light's on. They go around. They check the pressure. They fill it up. I'm on my way. Just sitting there. I remain seated at Big O Tires.
And see, I like to go into the sitting area mm-hmm. and use the Wi-Fi. But they're so fast, usually, that I don't get to finish whatever it was I was working on.
And it's even faster when you make your appointment online at BigOTires.com. They've got over 50 locally owned and operated locations. You make your appointment there. Now, you can make it for things like free tire rotations, flat repairs, air checks, alignment checks, that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. Your check engine light's on. But right now, you can save up to $120 instantly on select sets of tires at Big O through April 21st. Big O Tires, the team you trust. So my Aunt Nan
yes.
turned 80.
Yeah.
And for her 80th birthday, she wanted to do a big trip. And part of that trip was Italy, which I joined her on, mm-hmm. which we've talked about. Previous to that, she wanted to go to Ireland, which my mom and my sister went with her on that portion of the trip.
Mm-hmm.
And part of the reason she likes to go to Ireland, we all like to go to Ireland, is she did family history research and discovery of a picture of that matching satin jackets. But the weirdest part of this,
okay,
and they were taking pictures with my mom and my aunt and my sister, and oh my gosh, I can't believe
you look just like her.
One of them said, would you let me cut your finger and I'll cut my finger?
Well, no,
and what, we what, can be blood.
No.
She was serious.
Well, that's what they did back in the day.
Then I can have... Mm-hmm. This is how cuckoo...
curious, Gina, is this technically a list?
Oh, not technically. It absolutely is a list.
It is absolutely a list? Okay, well, then let me get this going here. All right.
It's Radio from Hell with another list, because people love a good list. X96.
I have a list of the 10 best pop culture Halloween costumes for this year. You might think it's a little early, but no, you got to start thinking about your Halloween costume.
I'll guess the most one of the most obvious ones and let you guess the other one, Carrie.
Okay.
Oppenheimer.
Yeah.
Robert Oppenheimer.
Yeah, and Barbie, of course.
And Barbie. Those would be the two most obvious ones. Are they on there?
My suggestion slash guess is... someone who attended Burning Man, and they have plastic bags on their feet around their, what are those sandals called? The
Birkenstocks?
Birkenstocks, yeah. That's what I would do.
That is a great one. Carrie, that is not on here, but I hope somebody takes it. Yes, of course, Barbie and Ken.
Yes.
Oh, Ken, of course, yeah. And Oppenheimer,
but
right?
Surprisingly, no? Oppenheimer is not.
No, Oppie is not on there.
And that is an easy costume to do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How about Lauren Boebert? Is she on there? Lauren Boebert at the theater?
There needs to be.
I was going to say, so there's always the slutty whatever, the slutty nurse.
The slutty congressman.
The slutty.
Yeah.
It's not on there.
Not on there.
But also a good suggestion. Let's see. Number 10,
okay.
This is a couple's costume.
A couple's costume. Oh, no, nothing's coming to me.
Beth and Rip from Yellowstone. That's easy. He's just a cowboy, she's a...
Birthday to Will Sargent.
Oh, okay.
Guitar player for Echo and the Bunnymen. All right, so there you go. Do we have a sponsor?
X96 welcomes Glass Animals September 5th to Utah First Credit Union Amphitheater. Ticket links and more are available at x96.com. No. No.
That's not right at all.
No, we did that already. I mean, you can have another drink.
I'm Beat Gina announcer Ronnie Ola.
Ronnie Ola?
Johnny Ola's formerly conjoined twin.
You were separated?
Separated at birth by surgery. And those who know me personally know that I'm a man of stature.
Yeah.
But I wasn't always tall enough. It wasn't until I made a wonderful discovery that I began to achieve the height I have today. Someone gave me a copy of How to Grow Tall, the wonderful discovery made by Professor K. Leo Mingus. Professor Mingus asked the question, why be short and stunted when for the mere asking, you can become tall and graceful?
That's all it takes is asking?
Write today, and the professor will mail you a free of charge the secret of how to grow tall. The secret may be used at home by either sex. Professor Mingus has made a lifelong study of the cartilage system, and he thoroughly understands it. Write today, the Cartilage Company, Department 117L, Rochester, New York. And now here's a man who always said, early to bed, early to rise, makes for a really boring life. Your host, Harry Jackson.
Oh,
thank you, Ronnie Ola.
Wow. Think your way to being taller.
I guess that's all you have to do, right?
That's actually what Bill's doing today, and Johnny Ola. They're both home working on getting taller.
They're both really concentrating, hard on getting taller. All right. I wish I was taller. Let's see, Jake is here. The randomizer has picked. Jake, are you there?
I am.
All right.
Good morning.
Jake, we're going to toss a coin to see who goes first. It will give you an advantage in the game. You call it heads or tails, please.
Heads, please.
All right, here we go. It is tails.
You're one step further away from winning these tickets to see Glass Animals September 5th at Utah First Credit Union Amphitheater.
All right, so Gina and Jake, I will attempt to keep score as well as run the game. All right.
And not be distracted by the beeps. Yes, we know it's still there. They're working on it.
Oh, they're not working on it. let's see now, Jake. The first question is for Gina because she won the coin toss. Multiple choice pop culture trivia. If Gina gets it correct, she gets the point. If not, Jake, I'll turn the question over to you and allow you to answer and steal the point away. So pay attention. It is Andy Garcia, the actor's birthday today. So that is who we'll be asking questions about. He was in a lot of movies.
Yes.
Gina,
mm-hmm.
In Ocean's 11.
One of my favorites.
Well, what did the Bellagio casino mm-hmm. and hotel let the crew do for the movie?
Mm-hmm.
Was it one? All you can eat chicken wings.
Oh, well, that would be nice. Yes.
Was it two? Free visits to the Chicken Ranch brothel for all you can eat chicken wings. Three, tap into their security system to get real surveillance footage.
Uh-huh.
Or four, stay at the hotel while they were filming.
I'm going to say stay at the hotel while they were filming.
Mm.
No?
No. Oh. Sorry. I nearly declared the game over.
No, it just started.
Jake, your chance to steal the point away.
Yeah, let's go number three.
Tap into the security system.
I'm surprised they would let them do that.
Get real surveillance footage of the casino. All right. The score is 1-0. Jake in the lead, and Jake controls the question. Jake, let's see. Ocean's 13.
I like that one, too.
You like that one, too? You know, when they send the film in the old days, they do it digitally now, but when they send the film to the movie theaters, mm-hmm. sometimes they put a different name on it.
To distract people.
Yeah. Ocean's 13 release prints were delivered to theaters with what fake title? Jake, was it one, That Very Special Movie? Was it two, License to Steal? Was it three, Spaceballs 3, The Search for Spaceballs 2? Or was it four, Milkmaidens 2, Smell That Dairy Air?
Mm.
I'm going to go with number one.
That Very Special Movie? No. Actually, that's what the Hewish Theater in Payson put on the marquee when they played Oh God.
Oh.
Yes.
Because they didn't want to put Oh God.
They didn't want to put God on the
That Very Special Movie.
It was That Very Special Movie.
Well, it must be number two then.
License to Steal. All right. Gina, 1 point. Kay. Jake, 1 point. Gina controls the question. Gina.
Yes.
What was Andy Garcia's first breakout role? Was it one, Gollum in Lord of the Rings? Two, Jake Peralta on Brooklyn Nine-Nine? Three, George Stone in The Untouchables?
Uh-huh.
Or four, Ernesto, a gang member in the first episode of Hill Street Blues?
Oh. Huh. Hmm. Untouchables?
Hmm.
Well, no?
He was in that, but that was not his...
Mm.
Okay. Jake, you control... The question.
Yes, I'm going to go number four, please.
Ernesto on Hill Street Blues. Jake, 2 points. Gina, one.
You're
Jake.
Kicking my butt, Jake, with Andy Garcia trivia.
Jake, you could you could take it away right now. Let's go with this one here. All right. Jake, Andy Garcia said it wasn't easy to do a serious scene with who and why. Was it one? Carl Reiner. Because Carl Reiner was so funny.
Yes.
Was it two, Brad Pitt, because the smell? Was it three, Matt Damon, because he was kind of funny looking? Or four, Catherine Zeta-Jones, because she lied about her age?
Yes.
We all know that.
She's older than she said.
That's a great one. I'm going to say number four, Catherine Zeta-Jones.
you handed me this one, Jake.
No.
Carl Reiner.
Carl Reiner. Extending. Oh.
Phew, I thought I was out, and I'm back in.
You're back in. It's now tied, and Gina controls the question. This could be the end right here. Let's see. Here we go. What movie made Andy Garcia famous?
Okay.
What movie? Was it one? Beverly Hills Chihuahua. Oh, by the way, these are all real.
Okay.
He was in all of
these
films.
He was in all of them.
Okay. One, Beverly Hills Chihuahua.
Uh-huh.
Two, Barb and Star Go to Vista Del Mar.
Uh-huh.
Three, The Untouchables. Or four, The Mean Season.
What one made him famous?
Mm-hmm.
The Mean Season?
Hmm.
No?
No. Really sorry. Jake?
The Untouchables.
Untouchables. Oh. There you go.
Yeah. That was a back and forth close battle there, Jake.
It was. You did good, Jake.
But you come out victor with tickets to see Glass Animals September 5th at Utah First Credit Union Amphitheater.
All right. Hang on the line. Mm-hmm. We'll tell you how to get those tickets.
I've got to go now.
Oh, where are you? Ronnie Ola, where are you going?
I've got to go get small. News now, brought to you by
See movies that see you at Salt Lake Film Society's Broadway Cinemas, Utah's home for independent film. Throughout April, enjoy Nicolas Cage films every weekend. This Friday, don't miss Adaptation and the Unbearable Weight of Massive Talent. Tickets and showtimes at slfstix.org. Well, Bill's sick today, so I'm doing the news. So my news is a little different sometimes.
Yes.
I pick the stories. Def Leppard frontman Joe Elliott has defended his band against accusations that they use backing tracks during their concerts.
No.
During a conversation with Stereo Gum, the singer addressed rumors that Def Leppard's performances are technologically enhanced. Quote, I don't normally comment on this kind of stuff, but a friend of mine sent me a link from YouTube, a recent posting from someone, I don't know his name, Chuck something from Testament. That's another band.
Okay.
Saying that that we use backing vocals. For anybody who thinks we use backing tracks, that must mean when they hear us, they can't believe how good we are for real. You tell them, Joe Elliott.
It makes me laugh that he felt like he had to.
Don't put up with that crap.
He had to defend this.
We got a text yesterday from a friend of the program that said SUU's under lockdown. And it happened right at the end of the show, so we didn't
And I couldn't get any real confirmation, so...
Here's the story.
What happened?
Southern Utah University students woke up to a campus alert Thursday morning, notifying them to the possibility of an active shooter. Law enforcement spent hours searching and clearing buildings. No shots were fired. No one was injured. No active shooter was ever located. A campus alert had described a possible suspect, but later the university said it's highly unlikely that there was a threat. By midday, the university had announced there was no longer a threat. Apparently, they got a phone call that said, oh, there's an active shooter here.
Yes, so that's all it takes anymore.
So, yeah, and they have to follow up on it.
Yep.
The university had been aware of a suspicious phone call alerting the school to an active shooter. The school sent out an alert describing the suspect as a white male, aged 20 to 25, long hair, black cap, black shades, green T-shirt. Apparently none of it happened. And this is, you know, one of those cry wolf situations. Or, next time there is a real shooter, I hope they react in the same manner. They took it seriously. They have to.
Yep.
And thank you to the friends of the program that sent that in. That's one of the things. You have a live local morning show here.
That's true.
We are here when you call us at 877-602-9696 when you see stuff.
But we didn't have time to make, people can make accusations on a text, but we didn't have a chance to track it down until the show was over.
And it was towards the end of the show that it happened anyway.
Yeah.
But always let us know what's happening out there, not just traffic. Arizona's attorney general said she will do all she can to mitigate the impacts of the Civil War-era abortion ban that the state Supreme Court ruled was enforceable this week. Attorney General Chris Mays, a Democrat and a hero, told NBC News in an in-person interview on Thursday that her office is refusing to prosecute abortion providers and patients. So they can say it's a law.
Yeah.
But if she doesn't,
prosecute it, chase it down, then big deal. It's interesting though, because the Republican Party know that this is not a popular thing.
No,
they know it's going to cost them. But the Republican legislature in Arizona did it anyway.
Mm-hmm.
When the judges said you could, they did it anyway.
The 1864 Arizona law outlawed abortion from the moment of conception, with the only exception being to save a woman's life. The attorney general says, I totally understand the fear that doctors, pharmacists, nurses are having right now in the face of knowledge that we're barreling toward potential implementation of the 1864 ban. I mean, talking about putting them in jail for health care.
For health care.
Jail for health care.
This is your Republican Party. I won't say, this is what it's become.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't used to be this way, folks.
No. Let's see.
The crazies have taken over.
United States Coast Guard and U.S. Navy teams teamed up this week and rescued three men found on a remote island in the Pacific Ocean, lost at sea for more than a week.
Oh.
The fishermen, all in their 40s, were stranded on an uncharted desert isle.
Mm.
And they took seaweed and they wrote help in seaweed on the, just like in the movies.
Should have ate the seaweed.
But they
I guess they had plenty of it around.
It worked.
Well, that's good.
And they were rescued.
I didn't think that would work, actually. I thought that only worked in movies.
I know. It really happened. Well, this is big news. And I don't watch these shows. You would think I would, but I don't. I hate the Bachelor stuff.
I don't.
I hate it.
I won't go near them.
The Golden Bachelor.
Yeah, the old guy.
The old guy. This is big breaking news from the Golden Bachelor. Jerry Turner and Teresa Nist are going their separate ways. The Golden Bachelor.
Well, isn't that the deal?
No, that just 3 months after their lavish televised golden wedding. It was a television event.
Oh, they had a wedding.
Just 3 months after they married, they've announced, Teresa and I have had a number of heart-to-heart conversations. You know, things you should have before you get married.
Before you, yes.
And we looked closely at our situation, our living situation, and so forth, and we've come to the conclusion mutually that it's probably time for us to dissolve our marriage. These shows are ridiculous. I don't know why people... I guess it's a distraction?
I suppose. Maybe, you know, there are times when you just need... Oh, yeah, Guy says we should have the Golden Divorce Show. I know some people, whom I respect even, that say, I just need something dumb. I need bubble gum, you know?
And it is, I guess.
But I would find other bubble gum.
I don't...
I'd find some
really
other gum.
I really don't get it. You know, speaking of divorce,
yeah,
there's a new thing called getting yourself a divorce ring.
A divorce ring.
So Emily Ratajkowski, you know, the
model
actress, mm-hmm. she got divorced recently, and she posted on Instagram a picture of her like with this giant diamond saying, look what I got for myself. I got divorced, and then I bought myself
a divorce ring. Well, guys have been buying divorce convertibles, so
it's the same
maybe
kind
it's
of
the same thing. Sports weather traffic.
So let's see. The Jazz, for some reason, decided to win a game finally. 124.
Just prolonging the agony.
121 over the Houston Rockets yesterday. Thank God this season's almost over. They have a game tonight. They're on the road. They play the LA Clippers. That's at 8:30.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't gotten together a lot of sports today. That's your sports. Weather, very nice today, very warm, very sunny. The National Weather Service is saying 79 for a high today. I'm going 80. I'm going all the way to 80 today.
All right.
For a high. A beautiful weekend, it looks like. Saturday, 75. Sunday, 70. Just sunny skies. The next chance for rain looks like Sunday night into Monday. There's about a 40% chance that things cool off back down into the low 60s, it looks like, for the first part of the week. Let me refresh UDOT here, see if anything new has happened. We've got a crash at the intersection 54 South, 40th West in Taylorsville. Northbound and westbound lanes are partially blocked there. Crash eastbound 201 freeway approaching Bangor Highway. The left shoulder is what's being affected there. And, somebody's saying we should get Victoria to report on the Bachelor shows. I bet she watches those.
She probably does.
We should check in with Victoria. So you can text us things like that or traffic if you see it. 33986 is where you do that. Don't miss the pre-release events this weekend for Outlaws of Thunder Junction at Haster Games. Get a first look at all the exciting new cards, play games with your local Magic community, and win fantastic prizes. Learn more at HasterGames.com.
Yeah.
We got a few minutes here. How was your trip to California, Jim?
Yeah, I took my daughter Jonesy to California with one of her friends to see this performer, Rule.
Rule.
Who I didn't know anything about.
R-U-E-L.
Yes. And performed at the Shrine Expo Hall on the USC campus. And the hall reminded me of Saltaire.
Oh, really?
Same size, same shape, same setup there.
Okay.
And it was packed.
Of course.
But it's a standing show. There are no chairs there.
Oh, okay.
Which is a problem for remain seated Gina Barberi.
Yes.
So go with her friend, and they found a place in the crowd where they wanted to stand.
Mm-hmm.
And he is like this positive, you should be nice to yourself, and like all of his songs are very, you know,
uplifting
and inclusive. And
and you know what, now that you say that, it doesn't surprise me, because knowing your daughter,
yeah.
He's the non-Mormon David Archuleta.
I mean, but and this, you would have thought it was the Beatles, the way these girls were screaming and crying, and they love rule. He's just nice, a nice boy.
So did you do what you said you were going to do, and that is stand at the back of the room with the parents?
So I stayed with her for a bit, and it's weird going to a show where you don't know any of the music at all.
Yeah.
And, like, it's like four or five songs in. I'm like, how does he have all these? He did, like, 17 or 18 songs. I'm like, this is nice, but.
But it all sounds alike.
So I wandered to the back. Where the parents were. Actually, speaking of parents, when we were going into the venue, they were checking people, and they were saying to people, no vape pens, no smoke, no alcohol, and they were checking everybody as they came in, and the girls went ahead of me, and they said that to them, no smoke, no vape, no, and then they saw me, and they're like, oh, you're here with your mom. Have a good time. And I'm like, am I so obviously the mom?
So this would have
in this crowd, yeah.
This would not have been the venue. Yesterday, I was out and about, day before yesterday, I was out and about and received three or four comments on the shirt I was wearing, which said, and they were all positive, keep music evil. You've seen me wear that shirt. Mm-hmm. This would not have been the venue for me to be wearing
no.
that shirt.
No.
Or would it have been?
No. But I lucked out. So I went to the bathroom, and in the bathroom, there was a folding chair. Just sitting there.
Waiting for you. Did it say Gina on it somewhere?
It kind of did.
That's why you went to the bathroom. You heard the chair calling your name.
Gina, I'm in here. Come in here.
Mr. Scott, beam me down a chair.
So you removed the chair?
I just left it. I sat in the bathroom in the folding chair.
Oh, I would have taken the chair out.
For a couple of songs. Not very long.
You didn't take the folding chair out?
No, because then I didn't want security to be like, hey, this is a no folding chair.
Because that's weirder to me that you're sitting in the bathroom on a folding chair.
That's really weird.
That's, to me, that's...
I didn't know anybody there.
Yeah, which
just
is...
Just a couple of songs.
All right.
I didn't need to hear all 18 songs.
We need to do something that will get Gina in trouble someday. Because you've never really been in trouble.
Why do you want me to get in trouble?
Everybody needs to get in trouble at least once.
But it's not fun getting in trouble.
Well, it's not fun at the time, but it's great stories afterwards, and you don't have any of those.
I just told a great one. I sat on a folding chair in a bathroom. That's fun.
Yeah, that's exciting.
No one else did that at the show. I'm the only person there.
That's an adventure,
Dina. That's living outside.
You know how I feel about bathrooms. I'm not super comfortable there in public bathrooms.
Boy,
that was
really
a dangerous thing to sit in the bathroom.
See. Oh, there's a soccer game tonight?
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. My sports was really crappy today because I was doing news. Royals soccer tonight, 7:30. And then tomorrow, Real Salt Lake at 7:30. So you got, you got Royals and Real and, both this weekend.
Says, come join us in the South End at the tailgates. We're all partying over there.
Thanks for reminding us.
Thank you. Let's see. Let's go to line two. Who is this?
I think it's time for me to come into work here soon.
Artie Fufkin.
Oh, hello, Artie.
Thanks for the heads up. You had Katie call me to make sure that I was ready to go to work.
Well, you were a little you were a little late yesterday.
You've been sleeping in.
I know I have. Actually, you know what? I discovered something really, really cool that you could do with your pets. And I guess this is safe. You know the Downy dryer sheets?
Yes.
You can rub them on your pets to make them extra smell to smell good when you cuddle them. Because I cuddle all of my cats, you know, like a lot. So if you dry, if you wipe them, you know, if you wipe them with dryer sheets, they're so much better to snuggle with.
So don't put them in the dryer with the dryer.
No, don't do that.
Don't do that.
Oh, don't waste them in the dryer. No. Just rub them on your pets. Rub them all over yourself. Rub them on your car seat. Rub them on people that you bump into, your coworkers. Those things are awesome.
Artie's making Downy sheets into gloves that he just wears around and touches things.
Oh, my gosh. You know, oh, and also I put them up in the dryer vents, like in the, what's it called? The vents, the air conditioning vents. Oh, and I've been putting them everywhere.
Oh, in the ventilation system. Okay. Wow.
Oh, absolutely.
How many?
Absolutely.
How many boxes have you gone through now?
Oh, man, I have a case from Costco. I'm going to go back and get some more. They're awesome.
Now, don't go now, Artie, because you got a show to do in about an hour.
Yeah,
you have to go after work.
You'll get stuck in there.
Oh, don't remind me about my show. You know what? Every time I come into the studio, I get nervous. Am I the only one that gets nervous before they go on the radio? I get nervous. I'm nervous because I have to do a show today. I love being on the radio, but for some reason, I get stage fright. You guys ever get stage fright?
Katie says she does.
Yeah. Katie does.
I've been doing it too long.
Well, I don't blame her.
Oh, now somebody points out.
Every time I crack open the mic.
Artie, somebody points out that you shouldn't be doing this with the dryer sheets because the cats will then lick themselves and the chemicals that are on.
Okay. Yeah, you don't want to.
Well, you know what?
Oh, problem solved. I actually groom my cats. So after I rub them with dryer sheets, then after I smell them, you know, and love them, give them a good love, and then I'll lick them clean. I'll lick the dryer stuff off.
Oh, I see. So you take
so
in the chemicals.
You'll get the chemicals.
All right. Well, yeah.
Oh no! Yeah, I'll just spit them. I'll spit them into a trash can.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, I see. I'm glad you have a plan.
So it'll be.
That's a great idea.
There you go.
Well, Artie, are you giving
my radio show today? I guess.
Yeah. Yes. Are you any prizes or anything you're giving away today?
Oh, Blocktober tickets! I'm doing a radio contest. Text win ticket. I love my jingle. I get so excited when I get to sing my little text win jingle. So anyway.
All right.
Well, so listen for Artie later to sing his jingle so you can win Blue October tickets.
Blue October tickets. Can you believe it? A radio contest. I'm so excited.
He's so excited.
Race against the machine at noon on the buffet. Oh. I face to face on my dumpster dive, you know, feature at 1:30. Because they're going to be in town tomorrow with the Punk and Drublick show, you know, with North
Dex
and Disconnect and all those other great bands. So I decided to do that. So.
That'll be a good show. All right. Well, thank you, Artie.
All right. Well, and I'm going to bring my dryer sheets into work with me.
Okay, good idea.
Everybody.
Good idea.
Stuff them in the ventilation system here.
Oh, yeah.
Please.
Do that.
Because there's something, all right, there's something funky
Thanks,
happening
Artie.
In here. Thank you, Artie. Thank you very much.
He's an idea man.
He certainly is.
I know we have a couple minutes here, and I found this, you know, those things people like. I found one lying around. A list.
A list. Oh, okay.
It's Radio from Hell with another list, because people love a good list. X96.
You'll have to tell me if these are true, Carrie.
All right.
Because this is a list of things men say and what they really mean.
Well, you know I'm not a real man.
I know you're not. You know. But you're going to have to stand in for one.
Okay, I'll pretend.
Although I've got this crazy ex. Oh, she was nuts. This crazy person.
And so when men say that, what do they really mean?
Well, it could mean that maybe they were a jerk and treated her poorly, and that's why she acted crazy. Maybe she's not really crazy.
Out of all my exes, I would have to say I treated most of them poorly, but one was genuinely crazy.
But you cop to treating people poorly, though.
But I'm the reason that most of the relationships ended that I was in.
That's very healthy of you, Carrie Jackson.
A lot of therapy.
Yeah, to get there.
But one ex I did have was crazy.
Was crazy.
Yes.
I was just joking.
That's a cop-out.
He's likely not joking. It depends on the context. It could be insulting, and maybe he realized that after he said it, so then he's like trying to save face by going, I was just joking. He really meant it. Yeah.
Work with anybody like that?
I like you. Translation is, you're good-looking and exciting, but I don't want to be in a relationship, at least not in a committed one.
Oh, when they say, I like you.
I like you.
I see.
They don't know how to tell you the truth.
Okay.
You're being dramatic.
Oh, never say that.
If a guy can't deal with a situation, doesn't know how to feel in a dramatic moment, he might call you out for being overly emotional and dramatic.
Never discount her feelings. No. Never.
if she is being dramatic, maybe there's a reason she's being dramatic.
Yes.
How do you know Tom?
That's a fishing expedition.
That's code for, did you sleep with him?
Did you sleep with Tom? Yeah.
How do you know him? Not just Tom, could be Mike.
Could be, yeah.
It's not you, it's me.
That's also
never.
That's those are words that should never be spoken.
Never. You look better without makeup. Now this says this statement could be partially true. However, treat it with caution because what men really mean is they like you with makeup, but not too much. A little bit. He doesn't really want you to go all natural, but, well, that's interesting.
You'd never say that. Never. You're just opening up Pandora's box with that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I was busy. We all get swamped, but if you care about seeing someone or simply want to let them know they crossed your mind, you'll have time to text quickly.
Mm-hmm.
Just a quick, hey. I'm busy at work, but by just disappearing and saying, what happened? Oh, I was busy.
Yeah, don't ghost them.
It takes 2 seconds to send a text.
Exactly.
She's just a friend.
Yeah, that's always a lie.
Never, never just a friend. You're not like other girls.
Oh.
While this is intended as a compliment, it means that all other women are lame and you should be grateful to be so far removed from your species. Most women don't like it when guys put down other women, regardless of their intentions.
Really? Okay. Even if she starts? If she starts piling on a woman?
Well, then I think you're...
Then I'm okay.
It's open season then.
Oh, okay.
I don't watch that. Guys like watching adult movies and going to seedy adult clubs. For whatever reason, many guys are convinced that all women have announced a war on adult entertainment. Oh, so lying about watching porn, is that what this is?
Is that what it is?
Women watch it too?
Yeah. Got news for you guys.
It happens.
Mm-hmm.
I'll call you. Unless you're going not...
I mean, if you genuinely
if you're
follow
going to
up...
Call,
yeah.
Don't say you're going to call and then don't
and
call.
And say, I'm not going to call.
And let's see, one more?
One more, last one.
Well, I didn't mean to do that or say that. No, if you did it or said it, you did it or said it.
You did it or said it.
Just own it.
Yeah, there you go.
We hope you'd enjoyed another list with Radio from Hell on X96.
It's really not hard. It's really not hard.
Crash at the intersection of 54 South 40th West in Taylorsville. Northbound and westbound lanes are partially blocked. And let me check our message stream. Nobody sent anything in via text, but you can always let us know what you're seeing out there on the roads. As long as it's safe for you to text 33986.
Imagination soar, jaws drop, spines tingle as you unearth cosmic wonder in the five-story Northrop Grumman. I can never say this.
Northrop Grumman.
Northrop Grumman IMAX Theater. Or spot constellations, enjoy laser shows in the Hanson Dome Theater. Clark Planetarium is something for everyone. To schedule a free movie ticket. Forgive me, I had a gin and tonic this morning. Clark Planetarium has something for everyone. For scheduling and movie tickets, visit clarkplanetarium.org.
There you go. All right. KXRK Provo. We'll take a break, play a song. And right after that, it's the Boner Recap Game, the easiest game to play. If you heard who won the boner this morning, you know the answer we're going to for the question of the thing.
We're giving away dashboard confessional tickets.
You'll get dashboard confessional tickets if you can tell us who won the boner this morning. If you heard it, easy. If you didn't, cheat. Go to x96.com and click on the boner voting for today. It's right there. It says winner right next to it. Easy. 877-602-9696.
I have a quick thing. A
quick thing? Go ahead. Quick thing.
So you know, my sailor son, Festus.
Yes.
He's on an underway.
On an underway.
He's on an underway.
He's at sea.
He's at sea.
Oh, okay. All right.
His first time out for a long extended period of time.
And did he find out where they're shipping?
Well, no. He's last week. He's like, Mom, I'm going to be gone for 10 days. If they don't tell me where I'm going, I'll talk to you when I get back.
Hmm.
So yesterday, I'm out walking the dog.
Okay.
I come home. I didn't take my phone with me on the walk, and I look down, and I have a missed call and a voice message.
Uh-oh.
Mom, we were close enough to shore that I had service, and I thought I would call you. You know, like a ship-to-shore
mm-hmm.
call. And I thought I would call you and tell you what the ocean smells like out here in the Bahamas. But you're not home, but now I'm not going to tell you.
So he's in the Bahamas. Picking up some cigars for the Admiral, probably.
Yeah.
We got to get these cigars back to the Admiral, so see you later.
Well, I was so bummed I missed his call.
Well, I have many questions.
Why don't you take your phone with you?
Yes.
Oh.
I would always take my phone. That's my first question.
Oh,
you're out for a walk.
Yeah.
Yeah. What if something happened?
You could get kidnapped.
Yeah.
I could. You're right. I would be
Or somebody could steal your phone.
I'm trying to think like Gina. You could get kidnapped. Someone could kidnap the dog.
Yeah.
My kid likes to go for a walk almost every day. I always say, take your phone
with
you. Yeah,
I mean, I usually, I just did it for, it wasn't a purposeful thing. I just forgot it. But I'm so mad because, and he said, I won't be back on shore till Thursday. I'll call you then. But
ask him if he can get me some of those cigars.
You want some of those cigars?
For the Admiral.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Admiral's cigars that he's, or something. You know, he's picking up a case of rum for the Admiral.
I'm so bummed. That's my little quick hello, sailor.
Was he breaking protocol by even saying where he was?
I don't know.
And are you breaking protocol saying where he was?
I don't know. There's a Navy ship somewhere in the Bahamas.
All the security.
You see why you should take your phone?
I'll give you the full update when he calls on
please.
Aren't you wondering?
No, a little. Curious.
Oh,
so many questions.
There's good
hello,
rum there.
Sailor boy.
Yeah.
Good rum out there.
Mm-hmm. Just because.
Heather and Roy said thanks for playing Foo Fighters.
Oh.
You don't have to thank us from Roy.
Roy.
Foo Fighters usually comes up. We play some Foo just about every day, I would say.
Oh, absolutely. All right. Well, let's see. It is time for the probably one of the easiest contests on the radio.
It's the Boner Recap. It's a chance for you to win tickets to see Dashboard Confessional coming to the Complex on October 15th. You can find out more information about that show at x96.com.
Charles is on the phone.
Hi, Charles.
Yeah. Hey, guys.
Hi,
thanks
Charles.
For having me.
Oh, thanks. Fine, Charles.
Our pleasure.
It's easy. All you got to do is tell us who won the boner this morning. Gina's going
to
run them down here for you. And you tell us who
try
won, and you'll,
it up.
You'll get those tickets.
Boner candidate number
Thank
one
you.
Was Sports Builds Character. This is a Texas family firing a $1.5 million lawsuit after students put peanuts in a peanut-allergic teen's locker. So he's a member of the football team, and he tells his fellow football players, guys, I'm deathly allergic to peanuts.
Like
they could
death.
Kill me.
Yeah.
Here's my EpiPen. So they thought it would be funny to put a bunch of peanuts in his locker and rub them all over his uniform. And I think the family is suing the school district because they didn't handle the discipline of this situation properly. He could have died.
Mm-hmm.
Boner candidate number two, COVID vaccine gave O.J. cancer. O.J. Simpson died yesterday, and it didn't take long for the conspiracy theorists to say, huh?
he was a perfectly healthy 76-year-old man, and then he got the COVID vaccine, and he had got this, they're calling it turbo cancer, cancer that comes on really fast and kills people.
None of that is true.
He had prostate cancer, and he just died from prostate cancer. It had absolutely nothing to do with the COVID vaccine.
Does not give you cancer.
And finally, number three, J.K., you're ruining Harry Potter for me. This is J.K. Rowling. Now, she's been a boner candidate before for her transphobic comments, but she just keeps going with it.
She keeps doubling down.
And a lot of the actors from the movies, Daniel Radcliffe and Rupert Grint and Emma Watson, they've all come out at various times saying, you know, trans women are women and trans men are men, and we support you and we love you. And she's still, as of yesterday, doubling down on her transphobic remarks. So those were the three candidates today. Charles, do you know who won?
Well, they're all equally bonerific, but I got to go with my gut and with number one.
Your gut is correct, because he could have died from... You think a peanut allergy is silly? It's not. It can be just... Luckily, he didn't put on the... They rubbed it all over his jersey and stuff. If he had just put it on... He could have had a deathly allergic reaction. So you're right. Sportsfield character was our boner winner today, Charles. And you are a winner today also. You get these tickets to see Dashboard Confessional at the Complex on October 15th.
There you go. Hang on the line. We'll tell you how to get those. All right. Oh, come on. It was just an attempted murder joke.
It's not funny at all. Now, when my daughter was in kindergarten, they were studying penguins, and the teacher brought in shrimp, like shrimp cocktail shrimp.
Yeah,
like, oh, we're gonna be penguins today, we're gonna eat. And she the kids had shrimp and tried it. And if you think about a kindergartner, there are a lot of kindergartners that have never tried shrimp, probably.
Yeah.
She one little girl in her class took a bite of the shrimp, instantly had a horrible allergic reaction. They had to rush her to the hospital. They didn't know, she'd never tried shrimp before. Didn't know she was... But there are food allergies that can kill you. It's not a joke. It's not just that you get itchy or something.
Here's a texter. My little brother has been deathly allergic to all tree nuts since he was born. Once in middle school, he was sitting two seats away from a girl eating a peanut butter cookie, and just the smell of it caused his throat to swell up. Wow.
That's scary, because you don't know until you have a reaction like that that you're allergic.
I'm very lucky. I'm not allergic to anything.
Not
so
even
far.
Like pollen or
kind
of thing.
That kind of thing, but not like food.
I'm gonna have to go to the hospital.
Yeah, or anything that would send me to the hospital. Exactly.
I tell people I'm allergic to cheese.
Because
they'll ask you. So you're at a restaurant and the waiter will say, "Any food allergies at the table?" I say I'm allergic to cheese, then they really will make sure there's no cheese in my, even though I'm not actually allergic to cheese. It's a lie.
You hear
I
that?
Lie.
You hear that? All the wait staff that ever existed? You hear that?
Yeah.
She's lying when she says that.
Don't sneak cheese in there.
Sneak some cheese in there.
I could die.
No, you won't die. Although you haven't had cheese, so maybe you are allergic.
See, you don't know.
Well, let's get some cheese
in here.
You
want to risk it?
Let's find out. We'll get a doctor on standby.
EpiPen on hold.
The whole thing. All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be back after these messages with some leftover news. Stand by for all of that. BigOTires.com.
The team you trust, Big O Tires. Over 50 locally owned and operated locations. We have the ones we regularly go to. Mm-hmm. But I found myself like in Ogden or St. George with my tire light coming on, my low-pressure tire light. Mm-hmm. Pull into any Big O Tires, and they will check your air pressure and fill up your tires for you. They'll just take care of that.
That's very nice. You know, we should do shout-outs to all the locations,
I mean,
they got them from Logan to Beaver. So here's a shout-out to the Beaver Big O Tire.
Okay.
All right? Hey, Beaver, how you doing? but they do all kinds of things. They do alignments, oil changes, air and cabin filters. I didn't realize how important those are, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
They really are. Brakes, batteries, shocks, struts, and more. Free tire rotations, flat repairs, air checks, alignment checks, check engine light checks, brake checks. You can make an appointment online, or you can just drop in. But I'd go to BigOTires.com, find a location near you. There's also coupons on the website. Big O Tire.
You know, I could have maybe had better bonus.
Well, those are good. Why?
Well, I mean, listen. I mean, I still have in that. So I have a little file that says boner on deck. That's where I put the ones that
I'm considering. That's where they're warming up.
Okay. Yeah, that's the ones I'm considering. Listen to some of these titles, and then maybe I'll tell you about a couple of them. Woman names newborn son methamphetamine rules.
That one kind of speaks for itself.
Yeah, well, it's not what you think.
Oh.
Yeah. Woman spreads dead brother's ashes in a packed club pool in Abizia. Police officer, no, I don't want to do that one. How about Gilbert Arenas podcast slams Utah. Move the Jazz to Seattle, he says. And it's pretty, it's just him slamming Utah.
Okay.
Aussie man fined over $2,000 for taking his pet python surfing.
I have questions.
He was just on a surfboard and the python was around his neck.
Around his neck. And so he's like, look at me.
If you fall and the python falls.
Yeah, that's why he got fined.
Exactly.
Yeah. Teen dresses up as married woman to rob bank.
How do you dress up as a married woman?
As you can see, I'm married. Yes.
Hello. I'm a giant.
I'm here to take money out of my husband's account.
I think that's exactly
what
he did.
My husband.
Yeah. teacher cuts girl's hair without permission. Now, here's one you really might want to hear this one.
Okay.
Trump aide Cassidy Hutchison claims Rudy Giuliani groped her on January 6th.
I believe it.
Yeah.
You want to hear?
I saw the Borat movie, so, you know.
You want to hear any of these? How about, woman names newborn son methamphetamine.
Yeah, when you're saying it's not what you think, I'm curious what that means.
Yeah, and I've had this in the file for a few days. It's, New South Wales, Australia. An Australian journalist, Kirsten Drysdale, is currently in a newborn bliss bubble, having recently welcomed her child with her husband, Chris. There's just one problem. Her son's legal name is Methamphetamine Rules.
What?
The New South Wales...
Well, that's just too hard to spell. He's going to have a hard time in kindergarten spelling.
Well, they call him MR. The Registry of Birth, Deaths, and Marriages... Now, see, so you think, oh, well, she's the boner candidate, right, for naming her kid? No, that's not where it is. The registry let the name slip through the cracks during its submission process, despite offensive terms being prohibited. A spokesperson told News.com that they've since strengthened their system to avoid it happening again. Okay, mistakes happen, but why would Drysdale name her child Methamphetamine Rules to begin with? Mm-hmm. She is a TV presenter and been working on a story which aims to investigate the answers to viewers' burning questions. One of them was, what can I legally name my baby? Okay. While researching for the story, the heavily pregnant Drysdale was trying to decipher what the register default names a child if a parent's first submission is rejected.
Okay.
And she wasn't getting a clear answer from the government. She was about to give birth. She decided this was perfect timing to take matters into her own hands as part of the story.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
We thought, what is the most outrageous name we can think of that will definitely not be accepted by the registry?
I see where this is going.
It was really just a lighthearted, curious attempt to get an answer to the question.
She thought, for sure, they're going to reject this.
Well, imagine Ms. Drysdale's horror when her initial outline submission listing her son's fake name was approved very quickly. Weeks later, Drysdale got quite the push present when the official birth certificate arrived in the mail, and right there on the official birth certificate, Methamphetamine Rules. I don't know how this slipped through, said the manager of the registry. I don't. Possibly they thought methamphetamine was a Greek name, said the reporter. They haven't really given us a clear answer how this happened.
Hi.
So
my name's Methamphetamine Rules, but you can just call me Meth.
That's
interesting.
I know, and so the registry would have been the boner candidate there. So now I'm going to have to, and then the Rudy Giuliani one is just.
All right, 9:20. Time now for some big boy news and opinuendo brought to you by
Dr. Cobble's aesthetics team focused on three skin therapy devices for younger, healthier skin. See for yourself. Attend their aesthetics open house 3 to 6 p.m. Thursday, April 25th. They're located at 9355 South 13th East in Sandy. Well, I am calling BS on Bill calling in sick today. I think I've discovered what he's really doing.
What?
Well, this just in. The paparazzi is out in Malibu.
Breaking news.
And they have spotted Shirley MacLaine savoring the good life, spotted enjoying a martini at lunch with pals. And Bill is a known pal of Shirley MacLaine. The 89-year-old acting legend was spotted dropping by Christie's Village Cafe in Malibu, sipping martinis and enjoying the sunshine. She'll be 90.
Oh, wow.
Next week. Actually, this is also an alert for Frank Chris to maybe go check on.
She's fine.
Shirley MacLaine. You know who else is fine?
Who?
Jewel and Kevin Costner.
They're still together?
Yeah. She's not doing anything to tamp down speculation she's dating Kevin Costner. In fact, she's leaning into the whole idea. During a wide-ranging interview this week with Elle magazine, the singer turned the conversation at one point to Costner, made her first brief open remarks about their special connection as she started blushing. Jewel told the reporter, "He's a great person. The public fascination with us is intense for sure." They're totally doing it.
Of course they are. Well, we found a guy in the chat room found the picture of Shirley MacLaine enjoying the martini.
She's entitled to enjoy a martini. Good for you, Shirley. Speaking of celebrities drinking things, this could have been a boner candidate.
Oh, okay.
Kourtney Kardashian took a unique approach to staying hydrated while under the weather. Quote, "This filter is crazy, and I just pounded a glass of breast milk because I felt sick. Good night," Kardashian wrote via her Instagram story on Wednesday. Kardashian showed a selfie of her lying in bed with messy hair and gave two thumbs up. Now, do we really think she drank a glass of?
I probably not. I mean, I just don't understand.
Any of it?
Any of it. The whole Kardashian thing.
No.
And yes, I said Kardashian because I won't say Kardashian.
Carrie insists on including the ass.
Yes, the gray lizard people are my Cardassians.
Now, can that hurt you to drink breast milk? Of course
no,
not.
No, you'd be fine, but
save it for your baby.
I mean, people do these things online just to get likes.
Yes.
You know? Just to get, you know, attention.
Not only will you not be able to sing the lyrics to your favorite Grateful Dead songs.
No!
But you're not going to get a refund either. Chris Mitrovich, they're calling this the next Fire Festival, by the way.
Okay.
Chris Mitrovich, founder of the annual Grateful Dead-themed music festival called Skull and Roses. This was Skull and Roses 6, was canceled, citing, quote, financial devastation from the 2023 show. Four-day festival had been set to kick off April 19th in Ventura. Mitrovich says the loss from last year's festival, which has been held annually since 2017, made it impossible to sustain the weight of a new production. Well, so they sent out a letter saying, "With deep sorrow, we must inform you that Skull and Roses 6 has been canceled. We are as devastated as you are. This is not our choice." And with regard to refunds, "While tickets and hotels were sold on a non-refundable basis, we sincerely wish that funds were available to refund your purchase for tickets. Unfortunately, it's not the case."
It was a grand ripoff.
Yeah.
It was just a grift.
Now, I understand sometimes if you're reserving a hotel and they give you a special rate and they say this is a non-refundable rate. But the tickets, paid for tickets and they're canceling the show.
Yeah.
So they just took your money. You shouldn't be a Grateful Dead fan.
Well, and that's, again, that's, you know, we've talked to concert promoters all the time who say don't buy tickets to these kinds of things because a lot of times they're fake.
Yep. So it ain't happening. The owner of Sis Sweets Cookies and Cafe put out a plea for help.
finding her $4,000 diamond, believing it may have fallen into dough and baked into a cookie sold at the shop in Leavenworth, Kansas. Dawn Sis Monroe said she noticed the center diamond of her engagement ring, which she hasn't gone a day without wearing in nearly 40 years, was missing last Friday after making cookies at her bakery. Bonus if you buy cookies today, she wrote on Facebook. My diamond is missing. My heart is beyond broken. It's been on my hand for 36 years. If you happen to find it, I would forever be in your debt if you would return it. She said she and her staff frantically searched the kitchen as soon as she noticed the marquee cut stone was missing. I looked down and the center diamond was gone. It probably fell on the cookie dough she was making. Now, it was either chocolate chip, sugar, or peanut butter cookies. They all were made that day.
So what kind of cookies are these?
Chocolate chip, sugar, or peanut butter.
But what's the brand name?
Oh, well, this is her. It's Swiss. Oh. It's Swiss Cookies and Cafe. It's
local
cookie shop. Right.
Okay.
She said you get a reward of free cookies for anyone who brings diamond.
I could take the diamond to a pawn shop and get money.
And then.
Or I could get free cookies.
Someone's going to turn it in.
Yeah.
I'm sure. Matthew McConaughey made his way to Hollywood 30 years ago in an interview with People Magazine. People Magazine, it's their 50th anniversary, so they're interviewing a bunch of people that have been in the magazine a lot. Matthew's been in a lot. He says, I, like anyone, have had my ups and downs. My star meter's been higher. It's been lower. I've won Oscars. I've also been arrested for playing the bongos naked, he offers.
Rightly so.
I've had ups and downs. He said, overall, there's been an inherent goodwill for me. But he says that there's not a lot of help when you start out in Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
And he would like to help young upcoming actors navigate.
I bet he would.
He would like to help you out.
All right. We'll get him on the phone.
Okay. It's probably a good idea to eat before you've head off to the supermarket. You've heard this before.
Yeah, my mom always insisted on that.
New research shows that grocery shopping on an empty stomach can lead to some serious overspending. In fact, the average person will fork out an extra $26 per trip when they're hungry. A poll of 2,000 Americans found that most people make 2 grocery runs per week. We go almost every day and just get...
Really?
Yeah.
You just get your ingredients for that day.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, all right.
Joe and I do this thing where because we have a neighborhood grocery store.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll take Riley, the dog,
mm-hmm.
and we'll walk to the grocery store. So we get grocery shopping and dog walking in.
Oh, isn't that nice?
All in one.
So does one of you stay outside with the dog while the other one goes in again? Well, it would be Joe going in.
Yeah, I'm not allowed to. I pick the wrong thing.
You would.
When I'm not allowed to grocery shop anymore.
If I go grocery shopping hungry, usually what happens is I wind up in the ice cream aisle.
And that's okay.
I will wind up in the ice cream aisle going, 2 pints or 3?
What's your go-to right now?
Well, Americone Dream. Ben and Jerry's. Mm-hmm. Although I bought some different flavors this last time that I was at the store. I haven't tried them yet. There was a peanut butter cup one.
Is it always Jenny's or is it?
No, it's always Ben and Jerry's.
Jenny's.
Yeah, Jenny's. It's delicious. Mm-hmm. I love Jenny's ice cream, but there's not enough stuff in it.
Do you know what I tried the other day?
I like ice cream with stuff.
So that local ice cream, normal?
Normal, yeah.
They carry it at Harmon's.
Mm-hmm.
They have an olive oil.
Oh, please, I'm way ahead of you.
But you know what you do on it?
What's that?
You drizzle a little balsamic vinegar on the top of it.
The olive oil ice cream. I tried to describe this to Tony, and he's like, ew.
No,
ew.
It's, like, no, it's so delicious. Good.
Oh, I love that stuff.
Olive oil ice cream with a little balsamic vinegar on it.
Ooh, okay, now I got to do that.
Mm.
Oh, all right.
Weather.
Now I'm hungry.
I'm saying 80. I'm going 80. All of the other weather people are saying 79.
All right.
You heard it here first.
I think they're being conservative. I don't think it's going to be 80.
I think it'll be 80.
All right.
Just beautiful weekend, though. Today, tomorrow, 75. Sunday, 70. Sunny skies. Next chance for rain looks like it'll be Monday night into Tuesday. 40% chance there, and we dip back down
into the 60s. Everyone wants their home to be more comfortable, functional, and beautiful, which is why Living Spaces has designed and developed the new Austin Collection. Their all-American look and family-friendly features. These pieces are an easy addition. Get them only at Living Spaces.
Listen.
There was a boy, a very strange, enchanted boy.
That's Kyle Brown, the very strange, enchanted boy. Longtime friend of the program, almost from the very beginning. And when he was just a kid in high school, and he's now an adult man, and we found out that Kyle had contracted ALS, which is Lou Gehrig's disease, and it's fatal. And it gets worse as it goes along. Kyle can't speak very well anymore, so he's been sending us letters. This is number 57, by the way.
57 letters?
57 letters, and we're thinking about ways to maybe compile these to all in one place so people could read them all. There's a possibility we could get them printed. If you work in a printing business, contact us here, and we'll talk about something like that. But this is the latest letter from Kyle. It says here, please refer to me as Emmy-nominated.
Well.
Kyle Brown.
All right.
Which he was nominated for some sort of sports special thing, and,
at the ESPYs.
Yeah. He says, I remember last fall watching the leaves fall from the trees and wondered if I'd ever see leaves again. Well, the leaves are back, but I won't see them change colors and fall. I got to see my daughter graduate via a webcast. My next goal, 4th of July. Working in the bike industry as I have for over the past 10 years, I've accumulated dozens of bike industry-related T-shirts. I really haven't bought T-shirts or socks in about 9 years. I almost feel silly wearing them now, being a cripple, but no sense buying new shirts. That would be a waste. No one knows what they mean anyway. We gave a bunch to the DI. I wanted to give more, but my wife, she wouldn't let me. I'm afraid my clothing will sit in my drawers and in my closet for years to come. Let me know if anyone needs size small T-shirts. Although it was very difficult for me, I'm glad I ended up going to New York. That was for the Emmy ceremony or ESPY ceremony, whatever. I'm glad my wife and my son got to experience all that they did. New York was lovely and nice people. Of course, we were in an upscale part of Manhattan, 2 blocks from Central Park. My son wanted to ride the subway and see giant New York rats. My wife wanted to sit in a cafe eating pastry on the sidewalk, seating, and stroll through Central Park sipping a latte. They both wanted to get all dressed up and go out. They both got to do everything they wanted to, and I was happy. Our flight attendant on the way to JFK Airport was David, a wonderful person. He was the fortunate one to welcome all passengers and let them know that in the flight entertainment system, let them know that the flight entertainment system would not be working during our four-hour flight.
Oh.
We chatted with and got to know David during our flight. A few years ago, he had stage 5 kidney failure, and he was told that he would likely die. He needed a kidney, a transplant, which was difficult to find, to say the least. So he set out to find one. He put up signs around town and on his car, as well as social media campaign, and he found a donor from a total stranger. Someone just being kind. I know that's hard to believe, but it's true. There are news stories about David online. We talked about something that I've said here a few times. We both wish that people could experience being given a death sentence, deal with it for about a month, and then have it rescinded and go ahead and live. Because when you know there's no tomorrow, it changes today. It changes how you act and react to everything and everyone. There's no way to emulate it or pretend. You have to experience the real deal. Everyone, take care of your body and your mind, and take care of your neighbors, too. Cheers, Kyle. Look over there.
There you go. Yeah, we'll figure out a way to get all of these letters either published or...
They'll be available in one form or another.
And we should make it a fundraiser of some sort.
I talked to Kyle's wife about that, and she's not necessarily in favor of that.
Oh, okay.
All right. Well, we'll work it out. let you know. All right, 9:36 right now.
You know what I did last night?
What?
I took a bath with hot water that just kept coming and coming, and I just didn't stop this. I filled the whole tub up with hot water.
Now, is this real?
It does. You never run out.
And it
and you have multiple people who have to shower and kids, and you don't have to time it out. You can all just shower right after another.
This, we're talking to we're talking to Larson HVAC, who came in and installed a on-demand hot water system in my house, and it really does work. Yeah, you can run the dishwasher while I'm taking a bath, and everybody still has hot water.
I'm just having a hard time wrapping my head around this technology, because I grew up with the old gas water heater.
That's right. That heats water all day, every day, whether you use it or not.
Exactly.
So it's nice to save some money and just have on-demand and as much water as you need.
And so you guys have that system that you did in my house, and then you've done some stuff in Bill's house too.
Yeah, so we did the dual fuel heat pump there, which is an amazing system right now that we're doing a lot of. We get some really good rebates from Rocky Mountain Power, Dominion, as well as tax credits. We did a direct steam humidifier there as well as in your house, Gina. Those work really great as well.
And you guys are doing good again. You're giving away some systems. Talk about that.
Oh, yeah, the contest.
Yeah, so we've had such a great response from all the great X96 listeners that we decided that we wanted to give away a product. So we decided to do either a new high-efficiency water heater, or if you have a new water heater already, then we're going to do an RO system, under the sink reverse osmosis system.
How does that work?
Yeah, I'm curious about this, because we have a similar system, but I'm not too crazy about it right now. So
yeah, so it's basically got a system that has four filters in it plus a carbon filter. So the water gets filtered several times. So it's basically bottled water quality without having all of the plastic, you know, that fills our landfills.
Mm-hmm.
You can cook with it, wash your vegetables with it, so you know you're getting good, clean water. We use it a lot for all those people that buy all those really nice mugs. You can fill them up with water every day instead
of Stanley's. Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah,
right. Instead of using all the bottles, that's great. People make coffee, instant coffee and teas and all that. It's good, clean, quality water that's right there on your sink on demand.
I think it's better than like your filtered water from your fridge, because that takes forever.
Yeah,
to like fill up. Well, ours did anyway. So.
This one actually has a little tank underneath there that's full all the time, so you can use as much.
Oh,
as you
I get it.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh.
And so you're giving away one of these systems. How are you deciding who to give those to?
So it's just going to be a random drawing. You just go to LarsonHVAC/X96, and all of the information is right there on our website. There's several ways that you can do entries for it. You can go to Facebook. You can you can tag people. Mm-hmm. A lot of different options there. And we're just going to put all the names into a hat and draw them on May 1st and announce that.
Yeah, on our Facebook page, it's going to be kind of fun. If you go and visit every day, we're going to be doing different contests to get you different entries. Like, show us a picture of your dirtiest filter for your furnace, or something like that. Or, you know, the oldest furnace or something. We're going to do a fun contest to get you more entries if you participate and tag people and things like that.
And your Facebook's just Larson HVAC?
And plumbing, yep. Larson HVAC and plumbing on Facebook.
You're doing more and more of the plumbing, aren't you?
We are. We've got the best plumber in town, Tyler. He's absolutely the very best that I've ever seen. So I love to.
He's got almost 20 years experience. Yeah. He's great.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
So LarsonHVAC.com/X96, and you can enter to win.
Yeah, thank you so much. And all the listeners out there, every day I hear from you guys, and I really appreciate it. Thank you very much.
And anything else about the weather's changing? It's warming up.
Air
anything?
Conditioning, right? Yeah.
That's right. So I'll let Jaden take that. She does all of the appointments for all the HVAC or the spring tune-ups that will be coming.
Yes, in fact, I think you're a VIP member, Gina, so I'll reach out to you. But you have to get your AC tuned up in the spring just to make sure it's going to be working well in the summertime.
Do it now before it gets too hot.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah. When it gets too hot, you don't want to be stuck without your AC working.
Exactly.
So you do all the maintenance before. We make sure everything is good and, you know, up and running. So if you are a VIP member of ours, we usually send you out an email. We do scheduling online, or I can schedule for our customers. But it's very important to do that maintenance, and a lot of people forget. So AC tune-ups coming up. Have that on your mind.
Well, yeah. I mean, if it goes to 80 like you keep threatening.
Yeah. It might. It's almost there today.
I think today, I think we get there.
I wouldn't be able to turn on the air conditioning because I haven't.
You got to prepare, Carrie.
I haven't done this, and I need to get you guys over to do it. Change the filter and all that stuff.
Yeah, we'll be starting them a week from next week.
Yeah, it should be about 70 degrees to get them done, which we're at. But next week it's going
to
be cold again.
It's getting back down
to
50s.
So probably we're hoping for the next week after.
Okay. Yep. Right.
So, yeah.
So LarsonHVAC.com/X96.
And while you're on the website, you can sign up for the tune-ups.
Yep. Right.
Excellent.
Thanks for coming in,
you guys.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
We're going to take a break, play a song, and after all that, it's the boner of the week. Stand by for that.
Things that must go on the radio.
Yes, indeed. These are things that are bugging you. They're plaguing your life. You can't stand them anymore. They must go. Things that must go from your life. You say, I know what I'll do. I'll send it to Radio From Hell. You put it in an email. Send it to radiofromhell@x96.com. Hopefully, when we read yours on the air, these things will disappear from your life, or at least it'll make you feel better. I'll go first today. I have one of my own. I get tons of junk mail in my email, and I'm trying to stop it as much as I can by unsubscribing, vigorously unsubscribing from things. But when you unsubscribe from something, first of all, you should just be able to click on unsubscribe, and that's it.
Yes.
But no, it has to jump to a web page, and sometimes it just says you have been successfully unsubscribed. Okay, that's fine. But then sometimes it says, please, why? Tell us why. Or it'll give you a list. We have all of these newsletters. Which ones do you want to unsubscribe from? All of them. Just make it simpler, please. And it's none of your business why I'm unsubscribing. None of your business.
You could just put, you suck in the
But I don't even want to take the time to do that. I just wanted to be done. Let's see. This one is, it says, good morning. You may use my name. Okay, Zane, I will. I have one thing that must go. As I get older, I turn 40 years old this year. I get more body aches and pains, specifically shoulder pain. Oh, just wait, Zane. Just you wait.
Shoulder pain. You're
shoulder
cute.
Pain. I pop in ibuprofen like eating candy. Please make this go away. Thank you, Lords. Zane. I'm sorry, Zane. It will just go downhill. I'm sorry.
I have a negotiation with myself every night before I go to bed whether I'm going to take ibuprofen or not. Because every night I feel like I need it.
Mm.
And then I'm like, but that's bad to take it every night. So I'm not going to. Every night.
This one says, you can use my name. It's Kirk. Calling for medical appointments must go. It's a whole song and dance about matching my availability with their availability. It's 2024. Please have an online calendar where I can click on a date and a time slot.
Oh, that would be perfect.
That would be a good idea. Yeah.
And then finally, this one, Cardboard Chris here from the box plant in Spanish Fork.
Okay.
I come to work this Monday and went to hop on my forklift, and I saw that somebody had used the forklift over the weekend. That's not a big deal, other than the fact that whoever this guy was left his Little Debbie wrappers all over my lift. I was a little bit annoyed, considering the fact that there was a garbage can 3 feet away from where I parked it. That was a little irritating. And then I came into work on Tuesday. More Little Debbie wrappers on my lift. And on the one next to it, the asshat who left them there also left one in the work bag I keep on my forklift. Please, Lords, make this guy go home with a tummy ache or something. Gosh dang. There are a lot of sweets there. Thanks for letting me listen, Chris. I was nowhere near that.
I don't know. You like the Little Debbies and you want to drive a forklift.
I was nowhere near the box plant. All right, Carrie.
All right. This one from Tristan. Found dog scams on Facebook must go. I didn't know about this. Good-hearted people share these posts hoping to reunite some sad-looking puppy with their owner. Then when it's shared enough times, the original poster changes it to an enticing link that can steal logins or other sensitive information. Your friends trust the link because you shared it. Please do your due diligence to avoid these scams. A quick search for the same language will show that the dog was found not only on a road in Utah, but also in all counties around the nation, and shared in classified and yard sale groups on Facebook. They also typically have comments turned off, indicating they don't really... They're not trying to answer questions or find the owner. I never pay attention to them. I look at the picture and go, I've never seen that dog. So that's as far as I go. All right, so this one from Johnny B. Although the clock changing with daylight savings is definitely a thing that must go, a bigger thing that must go is the news reports that lawmakers are going to discontinue observance of daylight saving time. For the last number of years, news and media report various schemes each spring and fall on how this abomination is going to soon leave our lives, only to have it remain, thereby dashing my hopes into the pits of hell. Either S and do it or get off the pot. At the minimum, at least stop telling us that all the daylight savings bunk will soon be coming to an end. With anger and wrath over daylight time changes, Johnny B. This one from Garrett. People replying to work emails sent to a huge list with received or okay, so that you spend the day deleting worthless emails in an already overcrowded inbox. Also getting a tiny nut in your shoelace, and it's not enough to keep it from going through the grommet, but it catches when pulling them tight. And when at a restaurant, you politely ask for no onions on your salad, and they come anyway. You pick them off easily enough, but, you know, you can still taste them. And finally this, Mike in Syracuse, thing that must go. Thousands of photos on my iPhone. They just keep accumulating, and I don't know what to do about it. Delete them, Mike. Gina?
This is from Boise Mark. Good morning, Lords. Here are my things that must go. Number one, people hiking on muddy trails. You are destroying a natural resource. Number two, people purposely feeding coyotes to attract them because, quote, it makes their yard feel more outdoorsy. Do people really do that?
Do they do that?
That's crazy. Yeah. People leaving trash along the trail. I personally cleaned up that area last week only to hike it this morning and fill a large hefty bag. And if there's a locked gate with a sign that says stay out, stay out. Thank you for your help in these matters, Boise Mark. From FOP Holly in West Jordan. My thing that must go is the logistics of the Republican caucus held at Kearns High School. It wasn't just Kearns High School. It was everywhere.
It was everywhere.
I went to the caucus. It was beyond unorganized. Everyone was given mixed or incorrect information. It started late. Come on, Republicans, figure it out. This was from Kari B. Things that must go, liking every text to let everyone know you've read it. This is like one of those progressives becoming your parents commercials. When someone sends you a text, they assume you're going to read it. You don't have to like it, love it, or send a thumbs up. It's just let it be. And finally, this Logan the Welder here. I strongly feel that the Living Spaces voice must go. Sorry to offend anyone. Well, I don't know. I have also heard from people that were upset that I wasn't singing Living Spaces. So I'm not sure what to do.
You can't
win. Make an executive decision, Gina.
Yeah, do it.
Living Spaces.
Things that must go on the radio.
Apple song from Everclear because...
Oh, on this day. I dumped out of it. I don't have it anymore, but it's Art. It's Art.
Lead singer.
Lead singer. It's his birthday today. I think he was born in 1965.
Was he? I'll take your word for it.
Something like that.
All right.
Yes. So here, your choice of stories, Carrie.
My choice of stories?
So I have some
leftover news.
I have some food, new foods.
New foods.
New Doritos, new ice cream, new 7-Eleven special. Or the benefits of taking a fart walk after dinner.
Oh, I already know that. They're calling it that?
Because that's what I called it.
That's funny.
Here, you want me to read
Great
this?
Great minds. I love this.
Marilyn Smith, a cookbook author and self-proclaimed queen of fiber. Fiber's very important.
Very important.
Recently took to TikTok to explain her and her husband's nightly ritual of fart walking. Yes?
Mm-hmm.
Fart walking. You fart while you're walking. The purpose of a 10-minute fart walk an hour after you eat helps reduce your risk of diabetes, get all the gas out of your system. You're not at home doing it.
Yeah.
You're...
Now, if you do it outside, not around people,
yeah.
It's called fart walking.
Yeah.
If you do it in the office, it's called crop dusting, just so you know.
She says when you're moving, your GI tract is also moving. It helps for a healthier gut.
Uh-huh.
It's good to do it after you eat. Helps move the food along.
Taking in the night air. Or taking out the night air.
And I guess you might need a fart walk after you...
Okay, yeah, tell me about these snacks. Start with the ice cream.
Okay, Baskin and Robbins.
All right.
New flavor.
Okay.
It's for National Gardening Month. I don't know how I feel about this.
Okay.
Marigold Dreamsicle ice cream. So Dreamsicle, you know what that is.
Mm-hmm. But Wendy's has got a Frosty right now that's a Dreamsicle.
But this also has marigold flower.
Or actual marigolds in it?
A light floral taste. I don't know how I feel about
that. I'll give it a try. Ice cream. I'll try anything with ice cream.
Doritos is announcing their Mountain Dew Baja Blast Doritos.
Doritos.
So
I'm not sure how.
So it's sprinkled all. So Baja, some sort of Baja Blast flavoring is sprinkled on top of a regular cheesy Dorito.
I can't imagine this because I've never had Baja Blast Mountain Dew.
Oh, you haven't?
No.
Well, you never go to Taco Bell. That's what
is
you do at Taco
you
Bell.
It?
You get the Baja Blast.
Oh, okay. That's why I've never had it. I thought I saw it in the stores. Anyway.
The chips, like the soda, are only going to be around for a limited time. The Baja Fiery Mango will be available at select retailers across the United States starting on April 14th.
Oh, it is in stores. Yeah. Katie says that Baja Blast is in stores.
But that's just...
But the Doritos.
Yeah.
All right. Tony, get on that.
And then finally this. Hmm? If you've ever dreamed about sipping a Slurpee out of a cowboy hat or a popcorn bucket...
I never have, no.
7-Eleven, boy, do they have a deal for you. This Saturday, April 13th, fans can fill up almost any cup-like container with Slurpee for $1.99 at 7-Eleven.
Well.
There are very few rules when it comes to bring your own cup day. All containers must fit in an indoor display with a 10-inch diameter, which means the entire cup could go under the dispenser.
All right.
And there's a limit to just one quirky vessel per customer, but regular cups are still available. But you can bring in whatever you like. Bring in your Dune bucket.
Yes.
Fill up your Dune bucket with Slurpee.
I got my Easter basket.
For $1.99. There you go.
Thank you. All right, boner recap.
Okay. Hi, Dave.
Hello.
How are you?
Dave, the flower guy here, and he was just talking to us off the air that it's warm outside. Normally, you'd be starting to mow lawns, but you're retired now. Yeah. So. No lawns for you.
Weird.
He says it feels weird.
It is, isn't it?
Let's see. I'm going to read the boner candidates from this week, and then Dave's going to tell us who the boner of the week is. Boner candidate number one from Monday. Well, that's quite an inheritance. An 18-year-old woman had an ingrown toenail removed in February and said, I want to do something special with the nail. I don't want to just throw it away. She had it made into a family heirloom necklace to pass down to kids and grandkids, and that's just gross and weird. Tuesday's boner candidate, autism is demonic.
Yeah.
A school in Florida, the Trinity Christian Academy, canceled an awareness time period for autism awareness due to a pastor at the school sending an email to parents saying autism awareness is demonic. That's evil,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
And a boner. Boner candidate number 3 from Wednesday. Hey, you need an abortion? It's simple. Just get a bus ticket.
Oh, yeah, that guy.
This is Mark Simone, a business analyst, who I think was on Fox News talking about
the
Arizona ban on almost all abortions, except for saving the life of a pregnant person. He says, you know, if you have to travel to another state to get an abortion, it's not the worst thing in the world. Just get a bus ticket and go. That was Boner Cannon number 3 from Wednesday. Boner Cannon number 4 from Thursday. Yes, there are dumb Democrats, too. Democratic Representative of Texas Sheila Jackson Lee is being made fun of for a statement she made about the moon during an event during the eclipse. She said the moon is mostly made up of gases. She claimed she was talking about the sun, which is mostly made up of gases. Yeah. But no, she went on and on and on about it and sounded dumb. Boner candidate number 4. Boner candidate number 5 from Friday. Sports builds character. A family in Texas filed a $1.5 million lawsuit against the school district their son attends after a bullying incident in October went too far. The teen is severely allergic to peanuts. The teammates knew this, and they purposefully put peanuts in the teen's locker and rubbed them all over his uniform. He could have died. He's that allergic to it. And the family is suing. Those are the candidates, Dave. Which one is the winner?
Number 2.
Number 2, autism is demonic.
I thought you might pick
We
that.
Heard from lots of friends of the program with kids that have autism when that one came out, and they were appreciate that's your choice, Dave. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
This actually, by the way, was brought to you by Experience the Magic and Enchantment of Cat and Cauldron, your premier destination for all things occult and metaphysical in Taylorsville, catandcauldron.com.
All right. Gina. Scorpions.
Yes. Where?
Las Vegas residency.
Oh, not the band.
The band. Yes. For
oh,
you.
Thank you.
Through May 3rd, just so you know, at the Planet Hollywood.
Thank
so
you.
All right.
Did Katie do us a thing?
I didn't... We're not going to do a promo, are we?
Oh.
Oh, we are? Because we're out of time.
and.
It's got to go to space and then come back in that amount of time.
Goes.
I mean,
and it's not,
I don't want to put off the Artie Fufkin show any longer than
there
I
it is.
To.
We got it.
Okay, there we go. So Bill happens to get a cold and take Friday off. I think he wanted another long weekend.
Or maybe he really is sick, but that means he gets the whole weekend to relax and recover.
I'm not excusing him from the show on Monday. If he isn't here, I'm marking him absent.
Not absent, that can't happen. So join us for all the things happening Monday, Radio from Hell show here on X96.
Thank you, David. Fine job as always, Katie. Live long and prosper, bitches.
Don't you know Bill's sick? Mm-hmm. And I'm scrambling to find boners.
Right. Artie Fufkin is next.